Thank goodness I checked my friggin' broadcaster's settings, because once again, it decided to act like my microphone doesn't exist. Oh my god. Okay. So, hello everybody. I'm super excited. We're about to play Mass Effect. And I'm very excited. Why does my computer need permission to play Mass Effect? You should never need permission to play Mass Effect. Because Mass Effect is amazing. Oh, shoot. Hold on. I'm an idiot and I didn't set this up right. Hold on. It's also way too friggin' loud. Hold on. Alright, you guys should be getting visuals in just a moment. Meanwhile, I need to get these face sliders for our Shepard's face, which I so lovingly picked out for us. Okay, beautiful. Alright. First, let's fix this. I don't want to blow your guys' ears out. If it's still too loud, or too soft, or too whatever, let me know. Okay, so we are going to start Mass Effect, and I'm so excited. This is one of my favorite game series of all time, and I'm really excited to go through the incredible story of Mass Effect with you guys with our own little Shepard. So we're going to start
Welcome
a new career.
Welcome to Alliance Military Database. Classified information requested.
It's time.
Secure connection.
Froggy's
connection confirmed.
Froggy's here. Shelties is here. I'm talking over the computer. Okay, so we have three options here. We could start as John Shepard. We can enter a new ID or select an existing info and basically use a Shepard we've already used. But we're gonna start a brand new Shepard, and then you can do custom male or custom female or quick start male or female. We're going to be doing a custom female.
Please log in to access your profile.
I'm just going to name her after me because we might as well, since I'm the one playing her.
Warning, data corruption detected. Please reconstruct profile. Confirm pre-service
Okay,
history.
So this is where we have the three pre-service histories. This basically chooses the past of our Shepard, so we're going to go through all three of them, and I want to hear you guys sound off on which one we should do. So, first we have Spacer. Both of your parents were in the Alliance military. Your childhood was spent on ships and stations as they transferred from posting to posting, never staying in one location for more than a few years. Basically a military brat. Following in your parents' footsteps, you enlisted at the age of 18. So this is basically kind of the generic sort of backstory. You know, your parents were military, you're military, you've accomplished some pretty awesome things during your military service, and that kind of is what gains the attention of the higher-ups in the Alliance in this story. So that's one way we can go. Next one is Colonist. You were born and raised on Mindwar, a small border colony in the Attican Traverse. When you were 16, slavers raided Mindwar, slaughtering your family and friends. You were saved by a passing Alliance patrol, and you enlisted with the military a few years later. So this is kind of different. You were born on a farming colony, it got attacked, you were saved by Alliance military, and you decided to join the military because, you know, it was, I suppose it was kind of a natural progression for you. So basically the way that the morality system works in this game, and I'm just explaining this for people who have not seen the game, because I know there are some of my followers that said they've not seen this game played before. Basically, there's Paragon and Renegade. Paragon is good guy stuff, Renegade is bad guy stuff. You're still a hero regardless, but, you know, you get really morally questionable when you start going to the Renegade side. So Spacer is basically kind of like the Paragon beginning, and Colonist is kind of the middle ground. The Earthborn one is kind of the Renegade start. You were an orphan raised on the streets of the great megatropolises covering Earth. You escaped the life of petty crime and underworld gangs by enlisting with the Alliance military when you turned 18. So basically, you're a reformed street gang member from Earth. I don't know necessarily reformed, but basically, you know, you're in gangs. It's a shitty situation. You decided once you were old enough, you're just going to sign up with the Alliance. This is kind of the bad girl sort of start to the story. And the other difference between these three is that we'll have they get mentioned every once in a while throughout the series, but in the first game in particular, there are mini quests that you kind of get that relate to your background. Okay, so Freggy's calling for Colonist. Hi, Shelties! So, I want to see Shelties' thing on this, because I know that we wanted to have our Shepard be... I was talking about what kind of Shepard we should have before we started this thread and this stream that is, and the kind of consensus in the chat room at that point was that we wanted to have a Shepard who, you know, was very much kind and loyal and compassionate to her teammates, but when it came to other people that she was dealing with that were getting in her way or messing with her teammates, she was pretty much a relentless bitch. Yo! Hey, Curry, welcome back! I feel like the Earthborn background would be more conducive to that kind of Shepard. Freggy's calling for Colonist. I would like to see what Shelties and Curry want to choose as far as the background. Oh, gosh. Earthborn. Alright, Shelty's calling for Earthborn. I feel like Earthborn fits better with the kind of Shepard that we discussed kind of playing with. So let's go with Earthborn for now. It's confirmed a fun background anyway. Okay, profile. So here is the backgrounds now. So that's how you got into the military. Here's your military background. Again, we go from Paragon to middle of the road to Renegade. So first one is Soul Survivor. During your service, a mission you were on went horribly wrong. Trapped in an extreme survival situation, you had to overcome physical torments and psychological stresses that would have broken most people. You survived while all those around you fell, and now you will live alone to tell the tale. So Soul Survivor is kind of a tough one. This one is, I think, probably kind of more the middle road one. Basically, there are these really nasty creatures that you sometimes find on planets that are huge, and basically she was the lone survivor of an attack of these things, and so, you know, that kind of thing scars you a little bit. You like the look of Ruthless. Alright, so War Hero. Early in your own military career, you found yourself facing an overwhelming enemy force. You risked your own life to save your fellow soldiers and defeat the enemy despite the impossible odds. Your bravery and heroism has earned you medals and recognition from the Alliance fleet. So this is kind of the Paragon way to go. This is, you know, you were just an exemplary soldier, and that's what kind of made you recognizable to kind of the higher-ups in the Alliance military. Ruthless! Throughout your military career, you have held fast to one basic rule, get the job done. You've been called cold, calculating, and brutal. Your reputation for ruthless efficiency makes your fellow soldiers wary of you, but when failure is not an option, the military always goes to you first. I forget what the actual specifics of the Ruthless story are, but basically it's that kind of thing where you're known for being that, you know, acceptable losses, the greater good kind of person that always does what needs to be done. Yeah, people think that Ruthless is the best, but yeah, I mean, I would say either that or War Hero. War Hero you can make very tsundere as well, but Ruthless might go better for the Earthborn background. So, Freggy is calling for Soul Survivor. Shelties wants Ruthless. War Hero. Everybody in the chat wants one of them, so I guess this decision's kind of up to me. Mm. The only part that kind of worries me about the ruthless thing is that it makes, you know, even your fellow soldiers kind of look at you like, this girl's crazy. Which we kind of want to be nice to our people, so I feel like Soul Survivor or War Hero actually might be better. You know what, let's go with War Hero. Let's go with War Hero. We're going to go with War Hero. Okay. Now, here's the way the battle system works. And hear me out before we go, before we start. Well, you can start voicing your opinions, but hear me out before you start going crazy yelling at me. There are three basic, the way that the first, this game's battle system works is there's basically three kinds of things. There's pure physical strength, there's tech abilities, and then there's like, it's basically space magic. It's called biotics. It's basically space magic. And basically these six kind of character classes are based off of mixtures of them. There's one that's pure strength, which is the soldier, one that's pure tech, which is the engineer, one that's pure biotics, which is the adept, infiltrator, which is strength and tech, sentinel, which is biotics and tech, and vanguard, which is strength and biotics. I personally love playing either engineers or vanguards. They tend to be a lot of fun. I would not suggest an adept. Adepts are very squishy, and I don't enjoy playing them. They are rough. Infiltrator is kind of OP, yeah. Infiltrator is a little OP. Infiltrator is fun too, so sentinel. I would be okay pretty much with anything but soldier, because soldier is kind of boring to play, or adept, because adept is very squishy. Yeah, Vanguard's good. Shelties is calling for Vanguard. Curry wants Sentinel. I'm sorry, Infiltrator. I'm trying to remember which ones Infiltrator's super fun. I do love playing around with biotics as a vanguard, though. See, I just like having both the tech and the magic abilities. That's just me. Yes! Having tech early in the game doesn't mean much more open chests and doors. That's another thing I should mention, is when you have tech abilities, naturally, it helps you to be able to unlock more chests and stuff. There's a lot of annoying mini games in this game. The mini games piss me off. Another thing we're gonna run into that you're gonna hate is the inventory system, but that's a long thing. Be a Jedi, I like I said, I'm not going full adept. I'm not going full space magic. I'm also not like the greatest person in the world at this game. Like, I play on easy mode, just freaking deal with it. I'm not getting salty. Well, I am at the inventory system. That makes me incredibly salty. Alright, so Shelty said Vanguard and Freggy said space magic, so let's go with Vanguard. Okay, I get to select a bonus talent. So when you play this game multiple times after you beat it the first time, you get bonus stuff on subsequent playthroughs. So our selected bonus is decryption, so this is actually going to help us get through doors and whatnot.
Confirm facial identity.
Hey, Red Celeste, yes, this is the first Mass Effect. Alright, so we're going to change our appearance. So I'm going to click away from the chat for a second, so I'm not going to hear anything you guys say. I'm going to put in, this should be very easy, don't mind me while I count, I have sliders that I already have set, so don't mind me while I do this. I'm white AF, so we'll keep that way. Scars we'll go back to once I'm done with the basic stuff. Maybe we'll give Gina Shepard some cool scars. Thank you. Don't mind me. I'm counting because I have numbers here. I figured I would get this done before the stream. 30. Like, I picked all this stuff before the stream so that we wouldn't spend 1,000 hours on, Yeah, I'm gonna keep these eyes. This layout calls for different eyes, but I'm not dealing with it. 30, 23. Whoa. And we'll play around with the eye color. Let's pick an eye color. I don't really care. I don't want it to look exactly like me. I really could give a flying crap. I like these bluish purpley eyes. Let's go with that. Because it's fantasy. Whoa. Okay. The mouth is where I'm gonna start going crazy because, yeah. The mouths are always so difficult. Okay. Because they always look stupid. Okay, so this is where I kind of went a little crazy with the mouth, where I kind of started messing with it a little bit. This weird, like, lips protruding from the mouth thing that happens here happens with every Shepard in this game. Every female Shepard in this game, anyway. There's really no way around it. It always looks weird. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Okay. Okay, and then the rest of this is pretty much whatever we want. I might give her a different set of lips, actually. The mouth pisses me off. It's so hard to get, like, a decent looking... I feel like this might be even better, actually. What do you guys think? There's also not a lot of hair options. Yeah, the mouths are always gonna look weird. All of the female Shepherds in this game do the duck face. It's a product of the character creator. I don't know anybody who has been able to finagle with it enough to get rid of that. Aside from, like, I guess making your own mesh and, like, really messing with the program, but, I'm not sure. I mean, if I really want to make her look like me, I have dark brown hair. This is probably the closest hairstyle to my current one, but I also kind of like the high bun, so I'm not sure which way to go. I would love to hear your guys' opinion on it. Yeah, we'll make the brow color the same. Commander Gina, yes. Wow! Are you guys talking about which one of us is gonna die first? You hate the bun because it has no sideburns. I never noticed that before. Yeah, that does look kind of weird, huh? She doesn't really have any sideburns in any of these where her hair is up. This is also a bun, but it's like a lower bun, and I think it looks really stupid in later games, but when later games, when we import our Shepard, we'll have the chance to mess with her again, so we can fix all of the oddities and change her hair color and hairstyle if we want to. So the hairstyle we pick here is not going to be indicative of the one we're going to get, quote-unquote, stuck with later on in the game. I mean, we could just go with this. I don't like the... I feel like the forehead, it looks like a huge forehead when you have this hairstyle. I don't like it. So maybe we'll just go this way. What do you guys think? I think this is a pretty decent looking Shepard. She doesn't look too bad. I think I did an okay job. Alright, so we're gonna go with this one, alright? Let's see what... Do I really want to put... Yeah, let's make me not look like death warmed over. Oh my god. I'm so dark and meaningful. No, I'm joking. I think that's fine. Well, that's no lipstick. That's fine. Yeah, I was gonna say, this is the kind of eyeshadow that I like to put on Shepherds because it's like generic, just darker shadow. I don't know. Whatever. Alrighty. We're finalizing our Shepherd.
Reconstruction complete.
Alright, we are an Earthborn war hero, and we are a vanguard, and we have decryption as our new special talent, which will help us because we're not going to have any tech abilities, which is going to suck, but it is what it is. Alright. Are we sure we want to confirm?
Yeah, identification confirmed.
Combat difficulty casual as fuck. I will never turn auto level on as long as I live. You can give me target assist if you want. We're here to have fun, not watch me fail 1,000 times. Let the squads, yes. Okay, subtitles and autosave. All good stuff. Here we go, opening cutscene.
Well, what about Shepard? Earthborn, but no record of her family.
Doesn't have one. She was raised on the streets. Learned to look out for herself.
She proved herself during the Blitz. Held off enemy forces on the ground until reinforcements arrived.
She's the only reason Elysium is still standing.
We can't question her courage.
Humanity needs a hero.
Damn right!
And Shepard's the best we've got.
Yeah, damn right.
I'll make the call.
In the year 12, I'm not going to read this out loud because it's going to go too fast. I didn't think it would say that. Yay! Mass Effect time! I hope you guys are so excited. I'm so excited. It's hard to explain Goth.
The Arcturus Prime relay's in range.
Oh, Seth Green! Sequence. Joker is bae!
We are connected. Calculating transit mass and destination. Relay is hot. Acquiring approach vector.
I'm also really excited because I'm
all
playing.
Station secure for transit.
I'm playing this on like ultra high quality for the first time ever because I haven't played the Mass Effect game since I got my new graphics card, and I'm very happy about it. Woo! There we are.
Board is green. Approach run has begun.
Go
Thrusters, check. Navigation, check. Internal emission sync engaged. All systems online. Drift, just under 1,500K.
1,500 is good. Your captain will be pleased.
I hate that guy.
Joker.
Nihilus gave you a compliment. So you hate him.
You remember to zip up your jumpsuit on the way out of the bathroom? That's good. I just jumped us halfway across the galaxy and hit a target the size of a pinhead. So that's incredible. Besides, Spectres are trouble. I don't like having them on board. Call me paranoid.
You're paranoid. The Council helped fund this project. They have a right to send someone to keep an eye on their investment.
Yeah, that is the official story. But only an idiot believes the official story.
Okay, so here's our first choice. So this is the kind of things you'll see. This, the top choice, the top on the right, is always going to be like the Paragon kind of choice. The middle one's always going to be like, you know, the middle road. And the bottom right is always going to be the asshole choice. And on the left will be like other conversation branches where we can ask different questions and details and whatnot. You'll also see special Renegade only and Paragon only choices, which I'll explain when we see them for the first time. But this is kind of our first opportunity to make a choice. So, do we think that this is really just a... I'm gonna say I agree.
They don't send Spectres on shakedown runs.
Right.
So there's more going on here than the captain's letting up.
Joker, status report.
Just cleared the mass relay, Captain. Stealth systems engaged. Everything looks solid.
Good. Find a comm buoy and link us into the network. I want mission reports relayed back to Alliance Brass before we reach Eden Prime.
Aye, aye, Captain. Better brace yourself, sir. I think Nihilus is headed your way.
He's already here, Lieutenant. Tell Commander Shepard to meet me in the comm room for a debriefing.
You get that, Commander?
He sounds angry. Something must have gone wrong with the mission.
Yeah.
Captain always sounds like that when he's talking to me.
Can't possibly imagine why.
Okay, so a little bit of explanation as to what's going on here. So, we are on the SSV Normandy. We are Commander, I guess, Gina Shepard. This is Joker, our pilot.
The captain's waiting for you in the comm room, Commander.
He's a very interesting character. We'll learn a little bit more around about him. This is Caden.
You probably don't want to keep the captain waiting, Commander.
We'll learn a little bit more about him as well. But these two are pretty major characters in the game.
We're getting dragged, right along with him.
Relax, Presley. You're gonna give yourself an ulcer.
Engineer Adams, one of my favorite characters in the game.
Congratulations, Commander. Looks like we had a smooth run. You heading down to see the captain?
Sounds like you don't trust our Turian guest.
Sorry, Commander. Just having a chat with Adams down at Engineering. It didn't mean to cause any trouble. But you have to admit, something's odd about this mission. The whole crew feels it.
Okay, so basically what's going on is Nihilus, that Turian that you saw in the beginning, is part of a group called the Spectres. They're a group of, I don't want to say mercenaries, but they're like military-type people that work for the Intergalactic Council of, you know, all the alien races, well, some of the alien races. It's complicated. But anyway, they kind of operate outside of the bounds of the law a little bit. So for this to be a simple shakedown run and for a Spectre to be on board doesn't quite match up, and the crew of the Normandy is kind of feeling that dissonance. We are the commander of the ship. We are second in command next to Captain Anderson, who you saw call for us while we were up at the front. So a lot of these people are looking to us kind of for leadership on how to take this. But I don't need to say what do you mean because you already knew it. I'll look into it.
I'll see if I can get some answers when I see him.
Good luck, Commander.
Yeah. Presley is a very interesting character as well. He's just a tad space racist.
There's something Nihilus isn't telling us about this mission. that's crazy. The captain's in charge here. He wouldn't take orders from a Spectre.
Not his choice, Doc. Spectres don't answer to anyone. They can do whatever they want. Kill anyone who gets in their way.
Correct.
You watch too many spy vids, Jenkins.
I mean, they can. It's probably not good for them to do it.
What do you think, Commander? We won't be staying on Eden Prime too long, will we? I'm itching for some real action.
I sincerely hope you're kidding, Corporal. Your real action usually ends with me patching up crew members in the infirmary.
Dr. Shaklaz is one of my favorite characters in the entire series. She has a level of sass that is like, she just does takes none of your shit. The doctor's right.
Only a fool goes looking for a fight, Corporal.
Sorry, Commander, but this waiting's killing me. I've never been on a mission like this before, not one with a Spectre on board.
Well, we want to support our team, so you'll do fine.
Just treat this like every other assignment you've had and everything will work out.
Easy for you to say. You proved yourself in the Blitz. Everybody knows what you can do. This is my big chance. I need to show the brass what I can do.
You're young, Corporal. You have a long career ahead of you. Don't do something stupid to mess it up.
Don't worry, ma'am. I'm not gonna screw this up.
Okay, so this is what I mean by the choices here on the left. So we can go to investigate it. We can ask them about their thoughts on Nihilus, on the Spectres, or on Eden Prime, which is where we're going. But I think that's pretty much self-explanatory. People are kind of nervous about Nihilus. I explained the Spectres a little bit, and Eden Prime is just the place that we're going to. It's a human settlement. The basics of this story is the humans got into to a certain point in space where they realized, hey, we're not alone in the universe. And then the Turians were like, hey, we haven't seen you before. You know what would be really cool? If we took over your planet. And so there was a war between the humans and the Turians, which kind of ended in, and I'm boiling this story down to like the bare basics. So I know that people that have played this game before are going to be like, that's not what happened. I'm boiling it down to the very bare basics. But basically, humans kind of earned their way into being seen as like the, as, you know, like a part of the universe, that a part of the galaxy that, you know, is actually viable, and they're not just these like really dumb, overreactive, like weird alien race that suddenly popped up. It's one of those great tropey things from science fiction where humans get out into space and realize that they're the, you know, the under-evolved ones, you know, they're the primitive ones in the galaxy when they thought they were so high and mighty. You know, it's one of those things.
Goodbye, Commander.
All right, we're going to go see the captain. We're going to go see Captain Anderson. Oh, see, and we get a salute from that guy. You're doing your job. Good job. 10 points to Gryffindor. I'll tell Anderson. Thank you. Oh, well, Anderson's not here, but Nihilus is. So let's have a chat with Nihilus.
Commander Shepard, I was hoping you'd get here first. It'll give us a chance to talk.
Okay.
What about?
I'm interested in this world we're going to. Eden Prime. I've heard it's quite beautiful.
They say it's a paradise.
Yes, a paradise. Serene, tranquil, safe. Eden Prime has become something of a symbol for your people, hasn't it? Proof that humanity can not only establish colonies across the galaxy, but also protect them. But how safe is it, really?
Okay, so now we learn a little bit about kind of the history of Eden Prime, that it's kind of exemplary of what humans, how humans can stand on their own in the galaxy. What's your point?
If you've got something to say, just say it.
Your people are still newcomers, Shepard. The galaxy can be a very dangerous place.
Truth.
Is the Alliance truly ready for this?
I think it's about time we told the Commander what's really going on.
Hey, Captain!
This mission is far more than a simple shakedown.
Oh, really? Who would have known that it was far more than a simple shakedown run? Oh my gosh.
I figured there was something you weren't telling us.
We're making a covert pickup on Eden Prime. That's why we needed the stealth systems operational.
Oh. So yeah, another thing about this ship, the Normandy, is they have this brand new technology, this brand new stealth system that no other ship really has. And that's why this crew in particular got picked for this mission, because the stealth abilities of the Normandy are going to be very useful for this particular mission. What are we picking up?
What's the payload, Captain?
A research team on Eden Prime unearthed some kind of beacon during an excavation. It was Prothean.
Prothean!
I thought the Protheans vanished 50,000 years ago.
Their legacy still remains. The mass relays, the Citadel, our ship drives. It's all based on Prothean technology.
There you go.
This is Big Shepard. The last time humanity made a discovery like this, it jumped our technology forward 200 years. But Eden Prime doesn't have the facilities to handle something like this. We need to bring the beacon back to the Citadel for proper study.
Obviously, this goes beyond mere human interests, Commander. This discovery could affect every species in Council space.
Yeah, so this is kind of an interesting thing. The last time they found Prothean technology, that was when humans found out they weren't alone in the universe, and that's what started all of this crap. But, you know, now it's something that's been found, and, you know, humanity has kind of the ability, you know, we have a couple of options here. Can we take the technology for ourselves and further humanity? Can we share it with the other alien races to show that we're willing to, you know, be civil with them and play ball, and that we can acclimate into the kind of grander society of the galaxy that humans are relatively new to? You know, there's all this interesting sorts of choices that we have here. So this is kind of a snarky move. Is why do we tell the council? Why wouldn't you tell the council? I'm glad you're here to help. You sound worried. You sound worried, Nihilus.
Are we expecting trouble?
I'm always expecting trouble.
Fair enough.
There's more, Shepard. Nihilus isn't just here for the beacon. He's also here to evaluate you.
Shut the what?
Guess that explains why I bump into him every time I turn around.
The Alliance has been pushing for this for a long time. Humanity wants a larger role in shaping interstellar policy. We want more say with the Citadel Council. The Spectres represent the Council's power and authority. If they accept a human into their ranks, it shows how far the Alliance has come.
You held off an enemy assault during the Blitz single-handed. You showed not only courage, but also incredible skill. That's why I put your name forward as a candidate for the Spectres.
Yeah, so this is a big deal. As you're going to learn probably within the next dialogue tree or two, the Spectre, there's never been a human in the Spectres, because like I said, humans are relatively new. So the fact that this guy, Nihilus, a Turian, a member of the races that initially started war with the humans, wants to put a human forward for Spectre candidacy, is kind of a big deal. But we're part of the crew, so I want to know, yo, Anderson, are you cool with this?
I assume this is good for the Alliance.
Earth needs this, Shepard. We're counting on you.
I need to see your skills for myself, Commander. Eden Prime will be the first of several missions together.
You'll be in charge of the ground team. Secure the beacon and get it onto the ship ASAP. Nihilus will accompany you to observe the mission.
Okay. So this is pretty much, so basically we're going to Eden Prime, and we're going to find this beacon that's old Prothean technology, and we're going to kind of see what we could do with it to figure out what technology could be held and what we can learn from it as a galaxy. So I think we're ready to go at this point.
Just give the word, Captain.
We should be getting close to Eden.
Captain, we got a problem.
What's wrong, Joker?
Transmission from Eden Prime, sir. You better see this.
Oh,
bring it up on screen.
Get down! I repeat, heavy casualties! We can't get evac! They came out of nowhere! We need...
Ooh! Get used to those sounds, kids!
Everything cuts out after that. No comm traffic at all. Just goes dead. There's nothing.
Reverse and hold at 38.5.
What the fuck is that? I know what it is, you guys.
Status report.
17 minutes out, Captain. No other Alliance ships in the area.
Take us in, Joker. Fast and quiet. This mission just got a lot more complicated.
Yeah, it
did. A small strike team can move quickly, without drawing attention. It's our best chance to secure the beacon.
Grab your gear and meet us in the cargo hold. Tell Alenko and Jenkins to suit up, Commander. You're going in.
Caden, that guy that was talking with Joker, is Alenko. His name is Caden Alenko. And Jenkins is the guy that was talking with the doctor that's like, oh, I want to go into
Engage
a battle!
Engage stealth systems.
By the way, just so you know...
Somebody was doing some serious digging here, Captain.
Oh, I'll wait for the...
Your team's the muscle in this operation, Commander. Go in heavy and head straight for the dig site.
Cookie!
What about survivors, Captain?
Helping survivors is a secondary objective. The beacon's your top priority.
Approaching drop point one.
Nihilus, you coming with us?
I move faster on my own.
Nihilus will scout out ahead. He'll feed you status reports throughout the mission. Otherwise, I want radio silence.
Ready and able, sir.
The mission's yours now, Shepard. Good luck.
We are approaching drop point two.
Okay, so,
ship perimeter secure, Commander.
So, Richard L. Jenkins, I will tell you that the L in his middle name... I will tell you that the L in Jenkins' middle name stands for Leroy, and I think that's all you need to know. aside from that, so here's our mission computer, which is basically our menu. We don't need to touch equipment right now, but you'll see the squad is lighting up. So this is our points. We're level one. This is our experience points. This is our health. And we have different talents. We have different weapons, different armor, and we have different biotic abilities, as well as decryption, which we got because we played this game over before. Yeah, Red Celesta knows exactly where this is going. Yeah, it's kind of a big spoiler, but not really a big spoiler. But so we can use decryption to help us get through secure doors and whatnot. And charm and intimidate are what kind of help boost our Paragon and Renegade. Here's the Paragon, here's the Renegade. You see, we have a little bit of Paragon. We don't really have much Renegade yet. So, we have 3 points. So, I'm probably going to be using pistols quite a bit. I would like to get a point in decryption. Okay, so decryption unlocked. It gave us an ability called Sabotage, which means we could use our description skill on easy level objects. And these circles and triangles are basically things that unlock and different abilities that you get from leveling up that far. Biotic protection and pistol and shotgun damage, yeah. And let's put one. This is assault training. Increases melee damage, increases weapon damage, grants the adrenaline burst ability. So yeah, we'll put it in that. Why not? I don't know. I throw points all over the place. I'm an idiot. I don't level people up correctly. Alright, so Caden is a sentinel. He is half biotics, half tech. So first aid is pretty cool. But I want to give him a point in that, and yeah, I'll give him a point in first aid. Deploys Medigel to all wounded squad members, so he can basically, he now has a heal ability. Medigel is kind of a one-all serve-all kind of thing. Jenkins, oh god. You know what, I'm just gonna do this. I don't need it. Okay. So, we're gonna go back. Our journal here, we can see missions and we can see all the points in the mission. These are assignments which are like side missions. And the codex is basically information on a lot
of
stuff.
1200 years ago.
They're voiced very nicely. If you want to read through all that stuff, and you know, they have information on history and different places and different planets. If you're interested in all that, feel free to look it up or buy the game and play it yourself. I highly suggest it. It's a great game. let me figure out, what is the quick save button? I think it's F5. F6, okay. I just want to make sure that I have the quick save button available. Alright, so this is a kind of over-the-shoulder, first-person-y sort of shooter. It's hard to explain. Alright, so here we go.
What the hell are those?
Gas bags.
Gas bags. Don't worry, they're harmless.
They're harmless. I think we get renegade points if we shoot them.
Damn!
I never heard him say that! So you also might have just heard him say, area is secure. When you see, when you hear your teammates call out something like that, it means that the area is secure and that the you're officially out of combat. This is an upgrade kit. Alright, high caliber barrel. So let's talk about this. This is our equipment screen. We have assault rifles, shotguns, pistols, and sniper rifles. We only have the ability to really use pistols. We can use whatever, but we only have like the pistol ability, so we're best with pistols at the moment. We also have grenade launcher. Because we are biotic, we have an amp. Amps are implanted in biotics to help them be able to channel and use their biotic energy. So all biotics have an amp, so we can add on to our amp. And here's our armor. So these are our add-on slots. So we just got high caliber barrel. Plus 10 damage, minus 20% rate of fire, minus 20% heat absorption. The more heat absorption you have, the less time that you have to fire. Minus 20% heat absorption is good. That means that we're going to be able to shoot for longer. If your gun overheats, you have to wait for it to cool down before you can shoot again. Bye, Cookie! So, we're going to put the high caliber barrel on. And we can also see here, this is our Medi-Gel. This is our, this is our Omni-Gel. This is our money. Yeah, it's generic things. I don't know. It doesn't really matter. I don't know why I'm explaining this to you guys. I don't know if you really care. Also, we have the map in the lower right that points to where we need to go. I do this every time where I can't remember where to go up here. I have to go up here. Every time I start this game, I run into this.
What happened here?
Is it too low for you guys, by the way? Too loud? Sheltie's going, area secure. Let's move! Move! Yay! He Leroy Jenkins himself! Good job, idiot! Alright. Woo! I'm a terrible shot, just so you know. Also, the combat in this particular game is very stiff. The other two Mass Effects, Mass Effect 2 and 3, do it much better. But this game is kind of stiff. All right, you've gained a level. So now we go back and we can use our points to up our shit. So pistols and Intimidate. And you can see that Jenkins is gone from our team. Spoilers, he won't be coming back. Okay, barrier. Alright, cool. So he's got more of a barrier now. And we'll give him more sentinel power. We'll level him up in dead sentinel though.
Perimeter secured. Smells like smoke and death.
Yeah, they'll also say random things if you talk to them. Or if you if you're just walking and you hear them go, huh, they'll have specific things to say about that area, but we're going to investigate our dead idiot friend here.
Rip right through his shields. We're at a chance.
He Leroy Jenkins himself. He literally just went, Leroy Jenkins, and ran into the middle of fire and killed himself. That is a specific Leroy Jenkins reference that the game designers put in. He deserves a burial.
We'll see that he receives a proper service once the mission is complete. But I need you to stay focused.
Aye, aye, man.
Alright, Paragon +2. I think it's going to be hard to go Renegade in this playthrough, I think. We might not.
I smell trouble!
Here we go. One of the most fun things about this game is that you can take cover like this. Let's use a biotic. Oh, you know what? Here we go. I want to get my biotic powers. I'm just setting up my powers. Alright, that's the overheat. Okay. So, biotic powers look something like this. Peace! Alright, there we go.
Got some burned out buildings here, Shepard. A lot of bodies. I'm gonna check it out. I'll try to catch up with you at the dig site.
Red Celeste, you weren't here for this explanation, but I can't split evenly between Paragon and Renegade. That's going to knock me out of a lot of different things. You kind of have to go one way or another. You can't be wishy-washy. You have to go do something one way or another. Alright. This is where the inventory system gets really dumb, because you start getting so many upgrades and so much armor that it's just dumb. Or you can reduce it to Omnigel. We're going to want to start reducing stuff to Omnigel eventually. But, armor plus 5 damage protection. Let's do that. Let's make Kaden hard. I'm funny. No, I'm not. Oh, Renegade next playthrough. I mean, I could have Shepard be Renegade in Mass Effect 2. She has plenty of reason to be Renegade in Mass Effect 2. You won't see why until we play Mass Effect 2, but I could see her becoming more of a Renegade. We could definitely do that. Wait till we get hit with biotic abilities and you see the ragdoll physics. What do I mean with Renegade? Okay. Paragon and Renegade. Paragon is being all good and sweetness and light. Renegade is being an asshole. We get Paragon and Renegade points based on what kind of dialogue choices we make and what kind of stuff we do. And going more one way or another unlocks different choices for us as far as what we can really do in this game. Oh, here we go. This is the girl from the transmission that we saw on the ship. What the hell are those things? I know what they are. Woo! Oh, you can also run. I forgot about that. Oh, these are the Geth that's wrong. I knew what they are, but... Yeah, these things are called Geth. We'll learn about them in just a second.
Thanks for your help, Commander. I didn't think I was gonna make it.
Gunnery Chief Ashley Williams of the 212. You the one in charge here, ma'am?
What happened here?
Give me a status report, Williams.
Oh, man. We were patrolling the perimeter when the attack hit. We tried to get off a distress call, but they cut off our communications. I've been fighting for my life ever since.
Fighting these things?
Any idea what kind of enemy we're facing?
I think they're Geth.
The Geth haven't been seen outside the Vale in nearly 200 years. Why are they here now?
They must have come for the beacon. The dig site is close, just over that rise. It might still be there.
Okay. Curry, so glad I'm not the only person that's not 100% fond of Ashley. I think she can be kind of cool, but she has a little bit of space racism going on. She's a bit complicated. She has a very practical view on alien-human relations, I'll put it that way. What is a Geth? Geth are, synthetic creatures. They're like, you know, robot-y machine kind of things that, that secluded themselves to a different part of the galaxy and haven't been seen in a very, very long time. So the fact that they're running around here now is very weird and not a good thing. I wish I could tell her to stay here, but you know, the plot's gonna fucking force her on us whether we like it or not, so I'll say take us there.
You're coming with us, Williams. We need that beacon.
Aye, aye, ma'am. It's time for payback.
Okay.
Move out!
Alright, so we get all this crap. Alright. So now it's teaching us how to... I already did this. Okay, so each weapon has damage, how many shots you can shoot before it overheats, and its accuracy rating. I don't like this pistol. It can go to hell. I don't want to equip it, and I'm not going to. What was the other thing that I got, though? Was it a... armor-piercing rounds. Yeah. Okay. Also... oh, no. I know how to do... why does it keep giving me this? I hate that it does that. Yeah, don't go too well. Yeah, I guess you could say what they really are. It's more, Geth have a generic consensus, like, they're different physical beings, but they all have the same, like, mind and consensus, like, they can all, they're a very interesting race. We'll give you that combat soldier, and I don't know what you're using right now, whatever, assault rifles, go do that. And we'll make you more soldiery. I don't know. I am not too fond of Ashley. She could be kind of a cool character, but... so the game is kind of just using this mission as basically a way to teach us combat. So showing us we could press left control to crouch. We're not going to be able to get him because he's behind those rocks. I don't really care. Crouching does make our shooting more accurate, though. Yeah, biatch. Alright. Marksman. Only boosts accuracy 60%, increases rate of fire, heats 30% to compensate. Not fun. Yeah, let's put a little bit of charm in there. That unlocks electronics. Let's give you some more decryption. It's so weird, like decryption and a couple of other things, they work in different ways. Some of them go on just your score, some of them go on the collective score of your team. It's very weird. I don't understand it. We'll give you shield boost. Enjoy that shield boost, though. Oh. Hey! Oh, see, so Ashley said ha,
negative
so...
contacts, Commander. Instead of just shooting them, there must be some reason behind
see, so she had something special to say.
They're using terror as a weapon.
Well, he thinks they're just impaling them on spikes to terrorize them.
This is the dig site. The beacon was right here. It must have been moved.
By who? Our side or the Geth?
Hard to say. Maybe we'll know more after we check out the research camp.
Alright, so, we can ask about survivors, however, we are very much about the mission, as, and Survivors are a secondary objective, we were told, so...
Let's get moving. Williams, where's the camp?
It's just on the top of this ridge, up the ramps.
Yeah, so this is
Chu-Chu. Same plan, Shepard. There's a small spaceport up ahead. I want to check it out. I'll wait for you there.
Okay. Alright, so this is more of all these things and blah blah blah. Yeah, no, it's only breaking down our shot. One shot, it's fine. I don't really like that. Yeah, whatever. I try to give them all as the best stuff that I can. It's not always feasible. Eventually, we're just going to have way too much stuff in our inventory because the inventory system in this game is ridiculous. Yeah, the robots are just kind of bodies to host the consensus. It's very hard to explain. Geth. Geth are awesome, though. I really kind of love the idea of the Geth, I'll be honest with you. Ooh, we got some new light armor. Yeah, okay, so this is better for us in every way. So yeah, we're gonna transfer our upgrades. Oh, we look sick! She has heavy armor. What about you? Yeah, you have basically the same thing, so. And in fact, I think we can actually Omni-gel that. Omni-gel is important for many reasons. Yeah, Geth are interesting creatures. A medical kit. All right, we got Medi-gel plus one. We didn't use any Medi-gel though, so that's fine. But I totally lost. I forgot where we were going. Okay, well, we're going towards that. That thing over there, and the smoke, and the terrible things. That is the direction we are going in. Oh no, that's where we came from. Wait. I'm so confused. Whoa, 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 whoa. Am I like a total moron? I'm having a day today, guys. No, we're going the wrong way. Yeah, because we're gonna go investigate this research camp. Yeah, these are some burned bodies. It's not good. Well, Shelties. Don't go having a bad day, girl. No, this is where we came from. How am I lost right now? No, I'm going the right way. Right. We have to go up this way. This I remember. Yeah, this is a much older game than Skyrim.
Camp hard.
It's a good place for an ambush. Keep your
guard.
Yeah.
Oh, these fuckers. Hey guys, do you like space? Do you like zombies? What do you do to them? Then you're gonna love space zombies! Woo! You freaking ain't just hit off. But break away from me! I know to do that. I know to do that. It's fine. Really, you're gonna...
Check your targets. Could be friendlies.
It used to be beautiful here.
Alright, I know where these places is. Alright, medium armor human. I'm just gonna be cycling through this stuff at this point, so I'm not gonna be commenting on everything that I find. Medium armor. No, she is medium armor, however. Yeah, however, that's... Yeah, we don't have any Turians in our party. I guess I can say yet.
It's closed. Security locks engaged.
There's people in there. I know what people are in there. It's a very weird conversation. I don't feel like dealing with it because survivors are second priority. Oh, yes, space zombies. That's literally what those guys are. They're space zombies.
Saren.
Oh, Saren!
Nihilus. This isn't your mission, Saren. What are you doing here?
The Council thought you could use some help on this
one. Alright, so he's a fellow Spectre member.
I wasn't expecting to find the Geth here. The situation's bad.
Don't worry. I've got it under control.
What was that? I know what it was, but anyway. Oh, by the way, interesting tidbit. I scrapped it, but, you saw the N7 on Shepard's chest? That is her military ranking?
Off in the distance.
It's a ship.
Woo!
Look at the size of it.
Look at that ship, y'all. What? Hi! Military ranking. Different military rankings in the Alliance are designated by letters, and they go through numbers 1 through 7, 1 being the like beginning rank and 7 being the highest rank. The N division is like their special ops, so Shepard is in the highest division of the special ops part of the Alliance military. And that is your history lesson for the day. Alright, so... Should we do this one? Yeah, let's play a mini-game. Can we do this? Alright, so these are decrypting mini-games. The manual overrides. It's a bitch. I hate it. Okay. Basically, we have to get to the middle and not hit into any of these things. If we hit into the red things, yeah, it sends us back to the beginning. There we go.
Everybody stay calm out there. We're coming out. We're not armed.
Is it safe? Are they gone?
We took care of them.
Those things were crawling all around the ship. They would have found us for sure. We owe you our lives.
I still can't believe it. When we saw that ship, I thought it was all over.
It showed up right before the attack. Knew it was trouble the second I saw it. So we made a break for the sheds.
Okay.
Tell me everything you remember about the attack.
I'm trying to get this out of here.
The three of us were working the crops when that ship showed up. We just saw it and ran. I don't know what happened to the rest of the crew.
They were by the garage, over near the spaceport, right where that ship came down. No way they survived.
Oh, we'll check
that
out.
You don't know that. We survived. If they made it to the garage, they could have had a fighting chance.
All right.
I have to go.
Hey, Cole, we're just a bunch of farmers. These guys are soldiers. Maybe we should give them the stuff.
The stuff?
Jeez, Blake, you gotta learn when to shut up.
If there's something you're not telling me...
Hey!
Some guys at the spaceport were running a small smuggling ring. Nothing major.
Really?
In exchange for a cut of the profits, we let them store packages in our sheds.
You greedy bastard. You weren't running for your life. You were running to check on your merchandise.
No, it's not like that. I just knew there were some packages here, something we could use. I found a pistol. Figured it would come in handy if those things came back. But you'll probably get more use out of it.
Okay. So here are the special kinds of... In certain situations, you'll have these special Paragon and Renegade things. If they're grayed out, you can't use them. We have enough Paragon and Renegade points that we can choose either one. Basically, these are both nice or asshole ways to get more out of them.
I'm only gonna ask this once. Think long and hard before you lie to me again. Are you sure all you've got is one lousy pistol?
Wait, I just remembered. I just had it in my pocket.
Oh, you just had it in your pocket, huh?
That's everything, really.
Who's your contact at the spaceport, Cole? What's his name?
He's not a bad guy. I don't want to get him in trouble. Besides, I'm not a snitch.
Now, you can see we don't have enough Paragon and Renegade points to do either of these, so we can't push the subject.
I have to go.
So, you know, that's the reason why. Like, there are some things that we're going to want to push that we need those extra Paragon or Renegade things for, so we can't... Ooh, nice. Yes, transfer those over. Caden, I like you better than Ashley, so I'll give you the better shit if I can. I know these are really better. Heard. That sounded like a gunshot. It couldn't...
Maturian? You know him?
He's a Spectre. He was with us on the north.
Something's moving. Over behind those crates.
Wait! Don't shoot! I'm one of you! I'm human!
What are you doing sneaking around back there?
I'm sorry. I was hiding from those creatures. My name's Pal. I saw what happened to that Turian. The other one shot him.
You didn't like him, Shelties? Well, yeah, you don't get to see much of him, so...
What the hell are you talking about?
There were two Turians here. Your friend and another one he called Saren. I think they knew each other. Your friend seemed to relax. He let his guard down. And Saren killed him. Shot him right in the back. Just lucky he didn't see me behind the crates.
Okay, so yeah, it looks like one of the specters, Saren, just turned on the whole lot of them.
We were told a Prothean beacon was brought to the spaceport. What happened to it?
It's over on the other platform, probably where that guy Saren was headed. He hopped on the cargo train right after he killed your friend. I knew that
Great.
Beacon was trouble. Everything's gone to hell since we found it. First that damn mothership showed up, then the attack. They killed everyone. Everyone. If I hadn't been behind the crates, I'd be dead too.
Okay.
We need to find that beacon before it's
too
late.
Yeah, we don't want to mess with you. We need to go.
Take the cargo train. That's where the other Turian went. I can't stay here. I need to get away from all this.
You go run for your life. Let the adults handle this shit. Oh yeah, okay. It's basically teaching us how to command our squad, so we can command them independently to go hide behind stuff or move to different areas. I don't really ever use that functionality unless it's like a very specific situation where I don't want them standing in a dumbass spot that's gonna get them killed. Okay, now we press the down arrow to make them leave the cover we told them to go to and follow us. Alright, this is where we learn. Alright, so this is how we use these guys' abilities. Hold down the space bar, throw, right there, and he will use his throw ability. Sometimes they get stuck. It's not a good. It's not gonna let us proceed until the throw hits it. So annoying. You can see there's plenty, and these are explodable barrels. Those are fun to use. That running is so cheaty. We didn't take the sniper class. We do have a sniper rifle, but it's not really useful to us. Also, I don't like sniping in this first game. Mass Effect 2 and Mass Effect 3 do sniping much, but they pretty much do everything gameplay-wise better. Phasic rounds, great. Alright. Gotta put a little charm in our step. Ashley. I just want her to be kind of a tank. She's really not that useful anyway. Kaden is not dying. His health automatically regenerates over time. He's fine. He's fine. Kaden's fine, children. You're so worried about Kaden. Do they matter? Yeah, they're our squad members. Of course they matter. If one of them dies, we can use Medi-Gel to revive them.
Set the charges. Destroy the entire colony. Leave no evidence that we were here.
Oh, wow! He's leading the Geth and taking the beacon. What a surprise. You jerk, Saren. Whoa! Oh, this is a fun little part of the mission. The white Geth are a pain in the ass. Oh, don't worry, Celesta. We're not going to let him get away with this. Or at least we're going to put our best foot forward to not let him get away with this. So, yes.
Demolition charges. The Geth must have planted them.
So we got to get rid
Hurry.
Of these.
We need to find them all and shut them down.
Correct. We have a little under 5 minutes at this point to get them. Don't worry. It's plenty of time. We're going to be fine. It's definitely not going to turn into our inevitable demise. I'm going to let these guys take some of the fire because here's the second charge. Alright, that's two down. Another one. Nihilus demands vengeance. Yes! We will get vengeance for him! Oh, here we go. This is the taking cover. Okay. I know what to do. I know how to do this. I never use that functionality. I'll get used to these. These are shields. We can pop them with a couple shots. Yeah, like I said, these white guys are annoying as hell. Thank you. Oh, I was starting to get a little down there, but that's all right. We're good. I'm gonna start healing, so it's fine. It's fine. We're good. We're good. Here's. I was gonna say I forgot where the last one was. I knew it was in this area somewhere. There we go. And that little sound means that we completed the mission. We completed that little mission, so... also, you'll see the little yellow hands. That means that they're not... They're currently staying where I told them to. Now I'm gonna make them follow me. Come on, guys. Come on. That's why I don't like placing them, because then they don't follow you. Oh my god, stop giving me that. I think it's just because it's the... oh, you don't... Oh, yeah, I have to unlock heavy armor for her. Truth. The Striker 2 is worse than what I've got. Oh, the sniper rifle's better. I like giving myself the best guns. And then I just go by who I like more. I will give you that. What's Omni-Gel that? My caliber barrel. Okay, that was just ours. Okay, let's go. Are you enjoying this game? Is that like a bad thing? You were saying this game is okay? This game is amazing. Hey, Husk! Dumbass. Yeah. All these fucking crazy... Like, we're getting... Oh, no. We're getting all these items, and eventually it just becomes cumbersome, and you're just like, I don't care anymore. Like... You know what I mean? Like, I just don't care anymore at this point. Okay. So, here's the beacon!
Normandy. The beacon is secure.
This is amazing. Actual working Prothean technology. Unbelievable.
It wasn't doing anything like that when they dug it up.
Something must have activated it.
Roger, Normandy. Standing by.
It's fighty, Shelties? Well, here we go.
No, don't touch her. It's too dangerous.
What happened to Saren? You'll find out.
We identified the ship that touched down on Eden Prime, the Normandy, a human alliance vessel. It was under the command of Captain Anderson. They managed to save the colony.
And the beacon.
One of the humans may have used it.
She just casually dodges. Gives no fucks.
This human must be eliminated.
Oh Yes, Curry! That is Deanna Troi from Star Trek. She voices that character. I won't tell you who she is yet because her name is a spoiler in and of itself.
I think she's waking up.
But yes, that is Marina Cernis, I believe is her name. Plays Deanna Troi.
You had us worried there, Shepard. How are you feeling?
How are we feeling? I'm okay.
Minor throbbing. Nothing serious. How long was I out?
About 15 hours. Something happened down there with the beacon, I think.
It's my fault. I must have triggered some kind of security field when I approached it. You had to push me out of the way.
Okay, so if you're interested in romancing Kaden, which I'm always interested in romancing Kaden, but someone, and by someone I mean several people in this group, want me to romance Garrus, so I don't know what I'm gonna do. But I will choose this just to have the option open for me in case we decide to go with Kaden. If you play a male Shepard, Ashley will get caught in the beam instead of Kaden, and she will be in this position. But if you tell him not to blame himself, that opens the possibility of romancing him. So we're gonna just open that possibility just in case.
You had no way to know what would happen.
That smile.
Actually, we don't even know if that's what set it off. Unfortunately, we'll never get the chance to find out.
We'll meet Garrus later.
A system overload, maybe. And the blast knocked you cold. Williams and I had to carry you back here to the ship.
I appreciate it.
Physically, you're fine. But I detected some unusual brain activity. Abnormal beta waves. I also noticed an increase in your rapid eye movement. Signs typically associated with intense dreaming.
More like a nightmare.
I'm not sure what I saw. Death, destruction. Nothing's really clear.
I better add this to my report. It may... Oh, Captain Anderson.
How's our exo holding up, Doctor?
Well, all the readings look normal. I'd say the command is going to be fine.
Glad to hear it. Shepard, I need to speak with you. In private.
Aye, aye, Captain. I'll be in the mess if you need me.
Sounds like that beacon hit you pretty hard, Commander. Are you sure you're okay?
I love that hot Canadian man meat. I do. I mean, I love Kaden. But when you guys meet Garrus, like, Garrus is pretty fucking fantastic, too. Yes, he is a Canadian. He is so Canadian, it's unreal. And he only gets more Canadian as the games go on. His Canadianness just goes crazy. I feel bad about Jenkins.
I don't like soldiers dying under my command.
Jenkins wasn't your fault. You did a good job, Shepard.
Okay. What happened to Williams?
Did we leave Gunnery Chief Williams back on Eden Prime?
I figured we could use a soldier like her. She's been reassigned to the Normandy.
We're not gonna go out of the way.
You said you needed to see me in private, Captain?
I won't lie to you, Shepard.
Good, Celesta.
Things look bad. Nihlus is dead. The beacon was destroyed and Geth are invading. The Council's going to want answers.
I hate the Council so much.
The Council can kiss my ass.
Woo!
I won't let them blame me for losing the beacon. I didn't do anything wrong.
I'll stand behind you and your report, Shepard. You're a damned hero in my books. That's not why I'm here. It's Saren, that other Turian. Saren's a specter, one of the best, a living legend. But if he's working with the Geth, it means he's gone rogue. A rogue specter's trouble. Saren's dangerous. And he hates humans.
Yeah, so you might have picked it up when Saren was talking to that blue lady. She is part of an alien race called the Asari.
My noble, I'm Harryar.
Oh, Dirty Harry! Thank you so much for following the stream. Welcome to the Choo Choo Club. Thank you so much for the support. And as I was saying, that the way that she spoke to him about Anderson, you could kind of tell Saren and Anderson might know each other, maybe a little bit. Curry, call the Council and hang up on them. Just hold your horses, we'll get there.
He didn't come to Eden Prime because he hates humans.
You're right. Saren has allied himself with the Geth. I don't know how. I don't know why. But it had something to do with that beacon. You were there just before that beacon self-destructed. Did you see anything? Any clue that might tell us what Saren was after?
A vision.
Just before I lost consciousness, I had some kind of vision.
A vision? A vision of what?
I saw synthetics. Geth, maybe. Slaughtering people. Butchering them.
We need to report this to the Council, Shepard.
They'll think I'm crazy.
Yeah. We don't know what information was stored in that beacon. Lost Prothean technology? Blueprints for some ancient weapon of mass destruction? Whatever it was. Saren took it. But I know Saren. I know his reputation is politics. He believes humans are a blight on the galaxy. This attack was an act of war. He has the secrets from the beacon. He has an army of Geth.
You know what time it is.
And he won't stop until he's wiped humanity from the face of the galaxy.
I'll find some way to take him down.
Yeah, we will.
It's not that easy. He's a specter. He can go anywhere, do almost anything. That's why we need the Council on our side.
Yes, Shelties, I'm taking my damn meds.
We prove Saren's gone rogue and the Council will revoke his Spectre status.
I'll contact the Ambassador and see if he can get us an audience with the Council. He'll want to see us as soon as we reach the Citadel.
Wait till you meet the Council.
We should be getting close. Head up to the bridge and tell Joker to bring us into dock.
Yes, sir! Captain Anderson, sir! Alright, so this is the med bay. Now we can go kind of on a little bit of a tour of this level of the ship.
Glad to see you're okay, Commander.
Yeah, here's Caden. We won't talk to him at the moment. This is Anderson's room here. Actually, no. Is this Anderson's room? Yes, this is Anderson's room. Here's Ashley.
I'm glad you're okay, Commander. The crew could use some good news after what happened to Jenkins.
Jenkins was a valuable part of this crew.
Part of me feels guilty over what happened. If Jenkins was still alive, I might not be here.
You're a good soldier, Williams. You belong on the Normandy.
Sure.
Thanks, Commander.
She survived.
That means a lot from you. I've never met anyone who was awarded the Star of Terra.
Yeah, that's the accolade that she won for all the crazy shit she did.
I need to go speak with Joker.
Goodbye, Commander.
I should go, by the way, is the joke of this. Shakwas.
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
We can ask her about Caden.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
She could tell us a little bit. This is where we could change our, Oh, yeah, we have items we can pull out of there. I'm an idiot. Okay, Beautiful. We could also sell items, which is something that we're definitely going to be doing at some point. Let's
Commander, I'm glad to see you're okay. Losing Jenkins was hard on the crew, and I'm glad we didn't lose you, too.
How are you holding up?
Things were pretty rough down there.
Yeah, you never get used to seeing dead civilians. Doesn't seem right somehow. But at least you stopped Saren from wiping out the whole colony.
I couldn't have done it without you.
We're Marines. We stick together. And I'm just sorry that we lost Jenkins.
Alright, we'll talk later.
I need to go see Joker.
Sure thing, Commander.
Paragon plus two. Now, I have a feeling this ship is actually going to wind up being a little more Paragon. So this is the elevator that could take us down into the basement area, which we'll go there later once we have more of a reason to. But these are the stairs back up to the main deck where we were before. I don't really care to talk to Presley at the moment. Oh, yeah. Also, this is, you can get Codex stuff, which just gives you experience, which, I mean, why wouldn't you want experience?
Good timing, Commander. I was just about to bring us into the Citadel.
Here we go.
See that taxpayer money at work.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Citadel. That's not the Citadel. That's a mass relay. But we're taking it to the Citadel. Just sink in this moment. I'm not even going to talk. Just...
Flagship of the Citadel fleet.
Well, size isn't everything.
Why so touchy, Joker?
I'm just saying, you need firepower, too.
That is a big ship, though.
Look at that monster. Its main gun could rip through the barriers in any ship in the Alliance fleet.
Good thing it's on our side, then.
Citadel Control, this is SSV Normandy, requesting permission to land.
Stand by for clearance, Normandy.
The Ascension? Yes, the Ascension is full of aliens.
Transferring you to an Alliance operator.
Roger, Alliance Tower. Normandy out.
The Ascension is the head
Normandy,
of the...
Normandy, this is Alliance Tower. Please proceed to Dock 422.
It's the head of the Citadel Council's personal fleet. And yes, yeah, so it is all aliens.
This is an outrage! The Council would step in if the Geth attacked a Turian colony!
The Turians don't found colonies on the borders of the Terminus systems, Ambassador.
Humanity was well aware of the risks when you went into the Traverse.
What about Saren? You can't just ignore a rogue Spectre. I demand action!
You don't get to make demands of a Council, Ambassador.
Citadel Security is investigating your charges against Saren. We will discuss the CSEC findings at the hearing, not before.
Captain Anderson, I see you brought half your crew with you.
Just the ground team from Eden Prime, in case you had any questions.
I have the mission reports. I assume they're accurate?
They are. Sounds like you convinced the Council to give us an audience.
They were not happy about it. Saren's their top agent. They don't like him being accused of treason.
Okay, so basically what you saw was those three people were the council members. One is a Turian, which you probably recognize. One is an Asari. And one is a Salarian, which we haven't seen Salarians yet. This guy is Ambassador Udina. He is the ambassador to the Citadel Council for Humanity. And he is the most gigantic dick in the entire world. I absolutely loathe this guy, and I'm sure you'll loathe him too.
I'm not gonna sit on my ass just because the Council doesn't want to do anything. If they won't stop Saren, I will.
Settle down, Commander. You've already done more than enough to jeopardize your candidacy for the Spectres.
Fuck you!
The mission on Eden Prime was a chance to prove you could get the job done. Instead, Nihilus ended up dead and the beacon was destroyed.
That's our fault.
That's Saren's fault, not hers.
Really?
Then we better hope the CSEC investigation turns up evidence to support our accusations. Otherwise, the Council might use this as an excuse to keep you out of the Spectres. Come with me, Captain. I want to go over a few things before the hearing. Shepard, you and the others can meet us at the Citadel Tower, top level. I'll make sure you have clearance to get in.
Yeah.
And that's why I hate politicians.
Yeah, really. So CSEC, which you mentioned a couple times, is shorthand for Citadel Security. Basically, the Citadel Security is going to be doing an investigation into Saren. Here we go. Okay, so now we have interesting things here. We can do the manual override, which is the mini game, or we can use 25 Omnigel to override it and not have to bother with it. I do not suggest wasting Omnigel on skipping the minigame. Yes, yes, Curry, I'm listening. Please tell me, so let's do this. Easy enough. Captain Hendrickson reports some unusual energy readings during a patrol of the Argus Row cluster. She had particular concerns about the Hydra system, but was recalled before her team could investigate further. No patrols are scheduled for that sector. Do we want to send in a recon team? So basically, we just got a side mission. unusual readings. So we're gonna go investigate the Hydra system in the Argus Row cluster. So yeah, you can unlock some side missions like that. There are a couple of side missions you can get by listening to the radio in the elevators here on the Citadel. Get to the council room, look at it from the top down for the best fucking okay, remind me to do that. Like, when I first walk in or when I get to, like, the very top, like, where the council is. Okay, I'm not gonna talk to these guys, but I'm just gonna introduce you. These big guys are Elcor.
These allegations are very serious.
If you can hear him.
This is serious.
And this little guy's a Volus. We're going to be talking to these guys a little bit later, but not right now. Elcor are interesting because they have no inflection in their voice. So when they speak to other people, other, like, alien life forms, they state their emotion before they speak. So it's very interesting. You guys will see it later on. Yeah, they're kind of space elephants, kind of. A little bit. They're pretty cool. Avina. Avina is basically all over the place. She's basically can guide us around where to go, because the Citadel is big. I don't remember if there's anything there yet to get. I don't think there's anything up there that we can do yet. How are humans inferior to those things? Well, they're very smart. Also, they could probably trample us. Alright, so these are Citadel transports. So once we see more of the Citadel, we'll have more places to hit. But all we could do right now is go to the Citadel Tower. I'm debating whether we should visit some other places first. Nah, let's go to the Citadel Tower first. We're gonna have plenty of time to run around after this meeting. So this is the very gorgeous Citadel Tower. Oh, here...
Saren's hiding something. Give me more time.
Hey, Garbus!
Stall the council. Don't be ridiculous. Your investigation is over, Garrus.
Garrus, my boy!
Commander Shepard, Garrus Vicari. I was the officer in charge of the CSEC investigation into Saren.
Yeah, so this is Garrus. He's a member of Citadel Security, and he was in charge of the investigation into Saren, so he is somebody that we definitely want to speak to right now. Hi, handsome, with your low-res face, Curry says. You don't like Saren. Actually, what did you find?
Come across anything I should know about?
Saren's a specter. Most of his activities are classified. I couldn't find anything solid, but I know he's up to something. Like you humans say, I feel it in my gut.
I think the Council's ready for us, Commander.
Good luck, Shepard. Maybe they'll listen to you.
And the ceremonious running in circles around Garrus. Garrus! Garrus! Okay, we're done. Now, where should I look down, Curry? What were you referring to? This is a very pretty pool, by the way. Yes, it's him. That is Garrus. That is the man. The man. That is Space Batman. Unlike you've ever believed in your life. Space Batman.
Don't be ridiculous. The Volus won't be joining the Council for years.
I'm not so sure. The humans are making a strong push, and you can bet the Volus will be right on their coattails if they succeed.
Yeah, this place is... you don't have much ground that you can really walk on, but... Find a top-down map of this room. Oh no. Yeah, I forgot about that. Welp. Hey, Anderson.
Hearing's already started. Come on.
Oh, I see it, Curry. I see it.
The Geth attack is a matter of some concern, but there is nothing to indicate Saren was involved in any way.
The investigation by Citadel Security turned up no evidence to support your charge of treason.
Yes?
An eyewitness saw him kill Nihlus in cold blood.
We've read the Eden Prime reports, Ambassador. The testimony of one traumatized dock worker is hardly compelling proof.
I resent these accusations. Nihilus was a fellow Spectre and a friend.
Sure!
That just let you catch him off guard.
Captain Anderson, you always seem to be involved when humanity makes false charges against me. And this must be your protege, Commander Shepard. The one who let the beacon get destroyed.
Hey, asshole.
You're the one who destroyed the beacon. Then you tried to cover it up.
Shift the blame to cover your own failures. Just like Captain Anderson. He's taught you well. But what can you expect from a human?
And yes, Curry is being very honest, Red Celesta. She's not being, like, facetious or anything. If she explains to you why that map is a thing, it will ruin the entire series for you. Don't worry, you'll find out. You'll pay.
You can expect me to kill you the next time we meet.
Woo!
Your species needs to learn its place, Shepard. You're not ready to join the Council. You're not even ready to join the Spectres.
He has no right to say that. That's not his decision.
Shepard's admission into the Spectres is not the purpose of this meeting.
This meeting has no purpose. The humans are wasting your time, Counselor, and mine.
You can't hide behind the Council forever.
There is still one outstanding issue. Commander Shepard's vision.
Don't worry, Celesta.
It may have been triggered by the beacon.
Are we allowing dreams into evidence now? How can I defend my innocence against this kind of testimony?
I agree. Our judgment must be based on facts and evidence, not wild imaginings and reckless speculation.
Do you have anything else to add, Commander Shepard?
You've made your decision. I won't waste my breath.
The Council has found no evidence of any connection between Saren and the Geth. Ambassador, your petition to have him disbarred from the Spectres is denied.
I'm glad to see justice was served.
This meeting is adjourned.
That is not the last we've seen of Saren, I promise you, Celesta.
It was a mistake bringing you into that hearing, Captain. You and Saren have too much history. It made the Council question our motives.
I know Saren. He's working with the Geth for one reason. To exterminate the entire human race.
Yeah.
Every colony we have is at risk. Every world we control is in danger. Even Earth isn't safe.
I'll let you guys know how we know Saren.
Tell me about this history between you and Saren.
I worked with him on a mission a long time ago. Things went bad. Real bad. We shouldn't talk about this here. But I know what he's like. And he has to be stopped.
We need to deal with Saren ourselves.
As a Spectre, he's virtually untouchable. We need to find some way to expose him.
What about Garrus, that CSEC investigator? We saw him arguing with the Executor.
That's right. He was asking for more time to finish his report. Seems like he was close to finding something on Saren.
Any idea where we could find him?
I have a contact in CSEC who can help us track Garrus down. His name is Harkin.
Forget it. They suspended Harkin last month, drinking on the job. I won't waste my time with that loser.
You won't have to. I don't want the Council using your past history with Saren as an excuse to ignore anything we turn up. Shepard will handle this.
Oh. The Captain deserves better!
You can't just cut Captain Anderson out of this investigation.
The Ambassador's right. I need to step aside.
I need to take care of some business. Captain, meet me in my office later.
Did humans kill his mama?
Cora's den. It's a dingy little club in the lower section of the wards.
I thought you said he was a drunken loser.
Couldn't hurt to go talk to him. Just be careful. I wouldn't call him reliable.
I should go.
Good luck, Shepard. I'll be over in the Ambassador's office if you need anything else.
That was the first I should go of the game, ladies and gentlemen. May there be many, many, many more.
Oh. I bet all these staircases aren't just for show. They make for good defensive positions if this place is ever...
That guy's up to something.
What guy?
Okay.
Over by the keeper.
So these are keepers. They are creatures. You're going to see them all around the Citadel. They go around just doing things. Nobody knows what they do. Nobody knows why. Nobody that runs the Citadel will talk about it. And this guy's fucking with one. This is part of a mission that we can get involved in, but it involves tracking down every keeper on the Citadel, and I don't feel like it. This guy, however...
No, I'm waiting.
Commander?
Oh. We can't... Okay, we can't deal with him yet. We could talk to him about something, but we don't have that ability yet.
Move on. He's just standing there.
Yeah. He's trying to figure out what they do. Doing? Did humans kill his mama? He's just... Okay, so we could go to Cora's den. Or we could go back to the embassies. Let's go to Cora's den. There's somebody else that we can meet as well. I probably should have made Anderson tell us about him. But there's another guy that we can run into as well. You've arrived at Cora's... Oh! Cora's den is a gentleman's club, but apparently, instead, we found some not-so-nice gentlemen. LOL. Assassins, in fact. Oh, shit. I forgot that button throws... I think I have to press the button again to make it explode. Yeah. You press R to throw them, and then you press R again to activate it. But anyway. So yeah,
A million light years from where humanity began, and we walk into a bar filled with men drooling over half-naked women, shaking their asses on a stage. I can't decide if that's funny or sad.
What? You don't think they're here because of the food?
Oh, Caden, you sweet little cinnamon roll. So yeah, welcome to Cora's Den. Super fun gentleman's club. It's great. It's fantastic. If we want to, we could sit here and watch this Asari dance. But we're not gonna do that. But this is the kind of thing that makes this game special, is it really lets you just kind of live a real life, and we can have a drink. Oh, okay. Well, we can... This guy... This is a Krogan. We'll be meeting plenty of Krogan later on in the game. Here we go. General Septimus.
Go away. I'm not interested in talking.
We might hit you up later. Oh.
Back off, Rex. Viz told us to take you down.
Oh, here we go, Curry!
What are you waiting for? I'm standing right here.
Rex!
This is Viz's only chance. If he's smart, he'll take it. He's not coming out, Rex. End of story. This story is just beginning. Am I weak, humans? I have no clue with you.
What was that all about?
Who knows? Let's just try not to get caught in the middle.
Oh, get caught in the middle. It's funny that you should say that. Alright, here's Harkin.
Hey there, sweetheart. You looking for some fun? Say, that soldier getup looks real good on that body of yours.
Oh, you like rack shelties?
Sweet
good, because that's...
Have a drink. See where this goes.
Oh my god. We'll see him. We'll get caught in the middle, alright? Shelties is all excited now.
I'd rather drink a cup of acid after chewing on a razor blade.
You trying to hurt my feelings? You gotta do better than that. 20 years with CSEC, I've been called every name in the book, Princess.
Call me Princess again and you'll be picking your teeth up off the floor. Now tell me where Garrus is.
Okay, just relax. Garrus, you say? You must be one of Anderson's crew. Bastard's still trying to bring Saren down. I know where Garrus is, but you gotta tell me something first. Did the captain let you in on his big secret?
Just tell me where Garrus is before this gets ugly.
But it's all related, don't you see? The captain used to be a specter. Didn't
what?
Know that, did you? It was all very hush-hush.
What?
The first human ever given that honor. And then he blew it. Screwed up his mission so bad they kicked him out. Of course, he blames Saren. Says the Turians set him up.
Oh, really?
Just tell me where Garrus went.
Garrus was sniffing around Dr. Michelle's office. She runs the med clinic on the other side of the wards. Last I heard, he was going back there.
I'm out of here.
Yeah, good. Go.
All right, so we gotta level up. But yeah, so next is to Dr. Michelle's place. That's the next place we're gonna be going. Kaden. We should probably give you... Oh, you only have two, right? So we got our information. We know where Garrus is, or we have an idea of where Garrus is now.
Why didn't Captain Anderson tell us he used to be a Spectre?
Maybe it's not true. Harkin's an ass. Bet he's just messing with our heads.
Possibility.
Probably right. Still, I'd like to hear what the Captain has to say about all this.
Yeah, we should probably ask him. I forget if this... This is... Let's go this way. If I remember where this goes correctly, this should be interesting. These are like... This is exactly where I thought it was. These are the lower markets, and these are the upper markets. Oh! Guys, it's Conrad Werner!
Wow, it's you.
Get used to this guy.
You're Commander Shepard, the hero of Eden Prime. I am so honored to meet you.
Okay, I have to decide how I want to handle him. Do I want to be an ass to him, or do I want to be nice? Should I be nice, Curry? Shepard's first and only husbando! Oh, God! Shelties is like, oh, God, no! Stay away from him! Should we be nice to him? We'll be nice to him. We'll be nice to him at least this time.
Nice to meet you. And you are?
My name is Conrad. Conrad Werner. They say you killed more than 100 Geth on Eden Prime.
I spent most of my time trying to stay alive and help the colonists.
Hey, I know you're probably busy, but do you have time for a quick autograph?
I guess.
Here you go.
Thanks. I really appreciate it. My wife is going to be so impressed. I'll let you get back to work. Oh, but next time you're on Earth, I'd love to buy you a drink. Thanks again.
Oh, nice seeing you, Conrad. All right, so this is the upper wards. This is the upper market, that is. There's lots of stuff we can buy here.
Look, I know.
I figured I would take the long way to Dr. Michelle's place because I wanted to kind of show you guys around a little bit. There's also some side quests we can pick up here. First of all, can we just appreciate this fucking view? The Citadel is so gorgeous. Can we talk to her? Yeah!
Excuse me, Commander Shepard!
Emily!
I'm Emily Wong. I'm an investigative journalist working here on the Citadel. Could I have a moment of your time?
What do you need?
I've been hunting for evidence of corruption and organized crime on the Citadel, but there are places I can't go. I was hoping you might share anything you find during your own investigation. I can make it worth your time.
I'm all for stamping out corruption.
Sounds like a good cause. If I find any information, it's yours.
Thank you, Commander. You won't regret it.
I love Emily Wong. They actually used, like, the official Mass Effect Twitter actually used Emily Wong in, like, a promotional campaign, like, tweeting a bunch of stuff when Mass Effect 3 was coming out, and it made me cry. Interspecies related. Okay. So, here's the medical clinic. This is Dr. Michelle's medical clinic, so let's go in here.
I didn't tell anyone, I swear.
Oh, God.
That's smart, Doc. Now, if Garrus comes around, you stay smart. Keep your mouth shut or we'll...
Who are you?
Let her go.
Hey, Garvis! Woo! I shot you in the face. Yeah, I was gonna... That's my throw ability, right? Sweet.
Perfect timing, Shepard. Gave me a clear shot at that bastard.
You took him down clean.
Sometimes you get lucky. Dr. Michelle, are you hurt?
No, I'm okay. Thanks to you, all of you.
Why were they threatening you? Who do they work for?
They work for Feast. They wanted to shut me up, keep me from telling Garrus about the Quarian.
Oh, so Shelties wants to know interspecies relations. Look. There are some issues with interspecies relations, some of which a character in Mass Effect 2 will teach us all about to a degree that is disturbing, but that's in the next game.
What Quarian?
A few days ago, a Quarian came by my office.
Quarians are another alien
She'd
race,
been shot,
by the way.
But she wouldn't tell me who did it. I could tell she was scared, probably on the run. She asked me about the Shadow Broker. She wanted to trade information in exchange for a safe place to hide.
Then what?
I put her in contact with Fist. He's an agent for the Shadow Broker.
Ah, the Shadow Broker.
Not anymore. Now he works for Saren. And the Shadow Broker isn't too happy about it.
Fist betrayed the Shadow Broker? That's stupid, even for him. Saren must have made him quite the offer.
Really?
The Quarian must have something Saren wants. Something worth crossing the Shadow Broker to get.
She must have something that proves he's a traitor. Did the Quarian mention anything about Saren, or the Geth?
She did. The information she was going to trade. She said it had something to do with the Geth.
Uh-huh.
She must be able to link Saren to the Geth. There is no way the Council can ignore this.
Time we paid Fist a visit.
This is your show, Shepard. But I want to bring Saren down as much as you do. I'm coming with you.
Okay.
Welcome aboard, Garrus.
You know, we aren't the only ones going after Fist. The Shadow Broker hired a Krogan bounty hunter named Rex to take
there
him.
There you go!
Yeah, we saw him in the bar.
You could use him.
A Krogan might come in handy.
Last I heard, he was at the CSEC Academy.
What's he doing there?
Fist accused him of making threats. We brought Rex down for a little talk. If you hurry, you can catch him at the academy before he leaves.
Move out.
Alrighty, so now here's the character select screen. So, obviously you could probably tell that this is Rex. These two characters, however, who knows? So this basically is where your character, you're going to see what your characters can do. The red is the combat strength, the purple's the tech, the blue is the biotic. This will show you Ashley's all, Ashley's all combat, Caden is biotic and tech, Garrus is combat and tech. He's an engineer, I believe it is. Let's take Caden and Garrus, and this will show you if these things are balanced between you and your squad or not. So let's get everybody equipped. I'm more worried about Garbus. He doesn't have medium armor unlocked yet. Yes, I call him Garbus. Why do I call him Garbus? Because I feel like it. My brother calls him Careless Librarian. It's pretty funny. Alright, he's got 10. Okay. I'm just gonna start placing stuff. I wanna keep him fairly balanced. That's right, he's an infiltrator. Wow, Curry, I'm an idiot. Yes, he's an infiltrator. He is a sniper like none you have ever seen. Oh, and also we can always come here to replenish our medigel whenever we want to. So that's pretty nice. Oh, here we go. That opens up a codex, but still, look at that nebula. Just look, it's gorgeous. She is kind of boring. Okay, we're going to go back to the embassies, and here's why. We're going to walk around a little bit. One, we could walk to the CSEC area from there, but also there is some really interesting stuff. Okay, that shows you where everything is and what everything is, but there are some really interesting places that we can visit, people we can meet, and side quests that we can pick up. So obviously we want to do all that fun stuff. This is the elevator down to the CSEC Academy, so that's where we'll be going to say hello to Rex. But for now, let's take a look around some of the other beautiful sights that they have to offer. Look, it's a Krogan statue. Isn't it beautiful? There's a reason why there's a Krogan statue in there. The Krogan have done some pretty boss things for the galaxy, which you'll learn about later, but anyway. Oh, we're not getting into this. I will tell you what this is, though. This is a Hanar. They are walking squids. Yeah, and they consider that, and they talk to themselves, they refer to themselves as this one. They're kind of weird. This guy is yelling, he wants to preach religion, and the CSEC officer doesn't want him to preach religion. I'm not getting involved in a religious spat. That's just never a good thing to do. This is not a ship, this is a space station. This is the Citadel. It is like the central hub of the galaxy. A lot of diplomats and politicians live here. There's a lot of big businesses and stuff. It's a gigantic space station. Ah, yes, Barlavon.
What's this? One of the Earth Clan. Ah, a very famous one, yes? You are the one called Shepard. It is a great honor to welcome the heroes of the Blitz.
You've got me at a disadvantage here.
Forgive me, Earth Clan. My name is Barlavon. My job makes it necessary for me to keep informed.
The Hanar is funny.
I am a financial advisor to many important clients here on the Citadel. When someone as important as yourself arrives on the station, I take notice.
Yeah.
Tell me more about the Shadow Broker.
So he works for the Shadow Broker.
Most people think I deal in finances, but my real currency is knowledge. I trade information, and it has made me very wealthy. But the Shadow Broker is the true master. Every day he buys and sells secrets that could topple governments, always giving them to the highest bidder. Yet somehow he never seems to upset the natural balance of power. All those secrets being passed around seem to even out. Nobody ends up with an advantage in the end.
Okay, so Celesta asked, does the Ascension protect the space station? Yes. The Ascension is the personal, is the head of the personal fleet of the Council. They protect the Citadel. They protect this entire space station. From outside threats, from external threats.
I should go.
Number two.
Goodbye, Commander.
So, if you push Anderson for another option besides talking to that drunken asshole, he will tell you to talk to Barlavon because Barlavon works for the Shadow Broker. The Shadow Broker is basically an information broker, the biggest, most famous information broker in the world. Nobody knows who he is. Nobody knows what he looks like. He's very secretive, as you might imagine. A lot of people have theories. Nobody really knows, though. So yeah, this guy you could buy some stuff from.
Ah, human. This one is greatly pleased to see you here in my decadent emporium.
I should be going.
I'm not gonna go through this with him.
As you wish. Do return when you are able.
I like the Hanar's voices. They're pretty cool. Alrighty, so let's go this way. There's another one of those keepers doing God knows what. Yes. Okay, it gives us a codex. Yes, this is where I wanted to go. So let's go over here and see what's over here.
Rearranged 5 times now.
5 times? Why? What do they want?
How should I know? It's not like keepers offer an explanation for what they're doing.
And yet, everyone just lets them go on doing whatever it is they do.
What choice do we have? If you try to stop them, they just shut down and another one replaces it.
Just strange that we know so little about them.
Yeah, those keepers. She says I should go a lot. That is like the official Commander Shepard line. Let's take a dip in here.
Welcome, I am Nelina. I don't recognize you as one of our expected clients today. Would you like me to see when the consort will be able to meet with you?
Okay, so this is the consort's place. The consort is a person that people go to for comfort, advice, a lot of things. Very popular woman.
Can't I just go in?
I'm afraid not. Yeah, you must understand there are many who seek the consort services.
Yeah.
But if you wish to leave your name, she'll make every effort to meet with you.
Why not? We'll leave our name.
Commander Shepard, with the Alliance Navy.
Excellent. You should hear something in, 3 or 4 months.
Yeah.
I think I'm done here.
Oh, well, I hope you'll return again in the future. We always enjoy seeing new clients.
Nelina.
Yes, Aira?
Send the commander up to see me. I wish to speak with her.
Yes, of course, mistress.
So yes, that's the consort, Shaira. And of course we have to linger on dad ass.
It appears the consort has taken notice of you. She'd like to meet with you now.
Where do I go?
Just head upstairs. She'll be waiting for you.
So this is basically like a place of comfort that people kind of go to. They can talk with people. Chat. Oh yeah, I remember this girl.
You're with the Alliance? My brother's a private back on Earth.
Well, good job. Yes, the Asari race is all female. Well, they're really genderless, but they're physically female to our... We look at them and say, oh, that's a female, but technically they're genderless. Hey, Shaira, what's going on?
That is close enough, Commander. I've heard a great many things about you since your arrival here in our Citadel. What exactly do you do? That depends on your need. I offer advice to some, comfort to others. I have a certain problem that could use your expertise.
Okay.
Maybe I can help. I have a friend, Septimus, a retired Turian general. I won't discuss the details, but... he wanted me to be more than I could be. We had a falling out. Now he spends his days in Korra's den, drinking and spreading lies about
me. Yeah, we ran into Septimus earlier.
If you could speak to him as a fellow soldier,
oh, here we go.
I believe he will listen to you and let the matter be.
Okay.
What exactly do you want me to tell him? Appeal to a sense of honor. Remind him of his position as a general. If you can convince him to stop spreading lies about me, I would be very grateful. Now I must ask you to take your leave. I have many clients waiting to see me.
Alright, so she wants us to go back to Korra's den and talk to that Septimus jerk. Which we can absolutely do.
I have to admit I'm a little nervous.
Yeah, it really makes it sound like they're just there for prostitution. I don't know if she actually sleeps with her clients. I don't know. We cannot sleep with the consort, if that's what you're asking. No, Shaira, we cannot sleep with her. She will cock-tease you into oblivion, though. That she will do. Okay. We looped around. We went a little too hard with the loop. Let's finish up some side quests before, because, I mean, we have a little bit of time left, so... let's go to Korra's den and take care of this for her. Especially because we're going to get to meet some other characters through this. Yeah, the Asari are like
down.
Oh.
Fist knows we're coming.
Oh shit! No! Right! Fuck! I'm not supposed to come back here until I have Rex. I don't want to do that. Hold on. Ah! Really? I totally forgot I should... It auto-saved before I walked in. Okay.
Never been a real fan of...
Alright, before we fuck ourselves over. Because I'm terrible. Okay, so you see, we have all these places now. Once we go to a place, we can go to them. But we want to go to... Alright, we can't. Alright, here's what we're going to do. We're going to go to the embassies, and we're going to walk, and we're going to go get Rex. Yeah, she is called a consort. That would imply that she does sleep with people. Maybe she does, but like she said, she offers comfort, she offers advice. You know, it's pretty much whatever you need. She's that kind of lady. Alright, let's go grab Rex, because I'm an idiot, and I don't remember what things are. Alright, let's go. Alright, so get ready for the longest elevator ride of your life. They use the elevator rides as basically loading screens. And this game is famous for them. Sometimes we'll have conversations, sometimes not.
In light of the recent attack on Eden Prime, many colonial investors are pulling their support for future projects. Proponents of expanded human colonization insist that Eden Prime was an isolated case. Nevertheless, colonist enrollment has dropped sharply.
That's not good.
Many colonial proposals are on hold until backers have some reassurance that human colonies will be adequately protected.
That sucks. I also love the sight of going down into CSAC for the first time. I just love it. Asari sex is weird. Because they do a mind meldy thing, it's hard. Alright, anyway. Hey, Rex! Buddy!
Witnesses saw you making threats in Fist's bar. Stay away from him.
I don't take orders from you.
This is your only warning, Rex.
You should warn Fist. I will kill him.
You want me to arrest you?
I want you to try.
Rex! My love!
Go on. Get out of here.
Do I know you, human?
My name's Shepard. I'm going after Fist. Thought you might want to come along.
Shepard. Commander Shepard. I've heard a lot about you. We're both warriors, Shepard. Out of respect, I'll give you fair warning. I'm going to kill Fist.
Fist knows you're coming. We'll have a better chance if we all work together.
My people have a saying, seek the enemy of your enemy, and you will find a friend.
I think we're going to get along just fine, Rex.
Yeah.
Let's go. I hate to keep Fist waiting.
So now we can ditch those lame humans. Oh, I just want to show you what these guys are like in combat, so we're definitely going to do that. Unlock fitness. Fitness increases his health. We're gonna make him a tank of all tanks. Oh god, I love him so much. Let's see. Can we give you anything good? Not really. Oh, we have some Krogan armor, but it's shitty. Let's Omni-Gel that shit. Thank you. Yeah, I really need to get more Omni-Gel. You need ridiculous amounts of Omni-Gel. Okay. So we're gonna go... Actually, I don't need to do this at all. I forgot there's a transport thing. Alright, so now we're gonna go back to Cora's den. Cora's den. Yeah, they do a mind meldy thing. Alright, so we got Rex and Garrus, so let's get ready for this level of insanity.
Looks like it shut down.
Fist knows we're coming.
I smell trouble!
Enemy is everywhere!
I love that scream. Enemy is everywhere! I think that's Garrus? I don't know.
Enemy is everywhere!
Bye-bye.
Enemy is everywhere!
Can I... Thank you. If Shepard dies, by the way, the game ends. Just so you know, it's one of those games. That's alright, we're good. Bye-bye!
I'm on it!
Get out of here.
I'm on it!
Really, Garrus? Garrus, don't step in my line of fire, you douche.
Line.
Not really, there's only one guy left. Are we okay, children?
Contacts, Commander.
Negative contacts. Alright, good. Glad to hear it. Alright, let's go. Let's go get this bastard. He doesn't deserve
Stop
to be right our
there.
Hubby.
Don't come any closer.
Warehouse workers. All the real guards must be dead.
Stay back or we'll shoot.
Okay. See, now I could really push them, but I only have enough, I don't have enough Renegade, but I do have enough Paragon.
This would be a good time to find somewhere else to work.
Yeah.
Yeah, right. That's a good idea.
Yeah, I never liked Fist anyway.
Yeah, guy sounds like a douche.
It would have been quicker to just kill them.
Shooting people isn't always the answer.
Truth. Not always, but sometimes it is. Alright, let's see if we can do this. Ah, fuck. I missed my chance over there. There we go. This is why I hate the inventory system, because, like, every time you dig something out, you're just sitting there, like... Do I upgrade? Is there a thing that I can do? You, and your fucking assault rifle. Alright. Phasic rounds, that's cool. There's Fist!
Enemy is everywhere!
Wait! Don't kill me, I surrender!
Tell me where the Quarian is and I won't have to shoot you in the kneecap.
Yeah!
She's not here, I don't know where she is, that's the truth.
He's no use to you now. Let me kill him.
Wait, I don't know where the Quarian is, but I know where you can find her. The Quarian isn't
that
here,
doesn't make so sense.
He can only deal with the Shadow Broker himself.
Face to face? Impossible. Even I was hired through an agent.
Correct.
Nobody meets the Shadow Broker, ever. Even I don't know his true identity. But she didn't know that. I told her I'd set a meeting up. But when she shows up, it'll be Saren's men waiting for her.
Tell me where that meeting is before I blow your lying head off.
Yeah!
Here on the wards, the back alley by the markets. She's supposed to meet them right now. You can make it if you hurry.
Woo!
What are you doing?
The Shadow Broker paid me to kill him. I don't leave jobs half done.
He kinda deserved it, though.
A lot of people died because of him. He had it coming. Now let's move. We have to save that Quarian.
Yep, and you might be able to tell from the sound, but we have a timer on this. So of course I'm going to sit here and start, you know, hacking shit, because we definitely have plenty of time. So we have to hurry. Yeah, I don't think you can really stop Rex from killing him. Nor would I really want to.
I'm on it!
Dumbasses. Out of my way!
Hold the line!
Garrus, you freaking loser. Are we done?
All right. All clear.
Yeah, all clear. Garrus, don't be stupid. I'm going, it's alright, we'll make it, I promise! I know what I'm doing, I checked this game before I started it up, I have 144 hours put into this game, I promise I know what I'm doing! Kind of! No, I know what I'm doing.
Did you bring it?
Where's the Shadow Broker? Where's Fist?
They'll be here. Where's the evidence?
No way. The deal's off.
Oh, Tali! I would date the shit out of Rex if I could, but he is not an option, unfortunately. God, I wish he was, though. I would date the shit out of him.
Fist set me up. I knew I couldn't trust him.
Don't worry about Fist. He got what was coming to him.
Then I guess there are two things I need to thank you for. Who are you?
My name's Shepard. I'm looking for evidence to prove Saren's a traitor.
Then I have a chance to repay you for saving my life. But not here. We need to go somewhere safe.
We could take her to the Human Embassy. Your ambassador will want to see this anyway.
Truth! So this is a Quarian.
You're not making my life easy, Shepard. Firefights in the wards, an all-out assault on Korra's den, do you know how many... Who's this? A Quarian? What are you up to, Shepard?
A Quarian, a Turian, and a Krogan. Like, I'm just basically here just to fuck up all your shit. What race is she? She's a Quarian. You'll learn a lot about Quarians. They wear these suits because they can't handle the atmosphere outside of their home planet. I know this word be offensive to some. They're basically space gypsies. They live on ships, and there's a reason behind it. They have a history with the Geth, and it's very complicated. You'll learn about it. Shut up, and I'll tell you, jackass.
This Quarian can help us bring down Saren. I would have told you that if you hadn't jumped down my throat.
I apologize, Commander.
Thank you.
This whole thing with Saren has me a bit on edge. Maybe we should just...
Yeah, space elves is a good way to put it, too.
My name is Tali. Tali Zora Naraya.
Tali!
We don't see many Quarians here. Why did you leave the flotilla?
I was on my pilgrimage. My rite of passage into adulthood.
Okay, so short story so we don't go through what the pilgrimage is. Basically, when Quarians reach a certain age, they leave the flotilla, which is the group of ships that they live on and travel around in, to see the world, gather interesting shit that can be useful to their people, and then bring it back. And if they bring back stuff that's useful enough, then they're considered to officially be an adult in Quarian society. So she's basically on her path to, like, becoming a full adult. She has to find cool technological shit to benefit the flotilla and then bring it back to them. So yeah, basically space elf.
What kind of evidence did you find? How'd you get it?
During my travels, I began hearing reports of Geth. Since they drove my people into exile, the Geth have never ventured beyond the Vale. I was curious.
Yeah.
I tracked a patrol of Geth to an uncharted world. I waited for one to become separated from its unit. Then I disabled it and removed its memory core.
I thought the Geth fried their memory cores when they died. Some kind of defense mechanism.
So yeah, basically they always wear these suits because their home planet was taken over by the Geth and they forced them out. So that's why they live on ships and travel around, because they don't have a home planet anymore. But the Geth retreated after that. They stayed there and nobody's seen them up until now. But yeah, Geth fry their memory cores when they die, so yeah.
What did you find out?
Most of the core was wiped clean. but I salvaged something from its audio banks.
Eden Prime was a major victory. The beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
That's Saren's voice. This proves he was involved in the attack.
Saren won't get out of this one.
Wait, there's more. Saren wasn't working alone.
Here we go!
Eden Prime was a major victory. The beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
And one step closer to the return of the Reapers.
I don't recognize that other voice, the one talking about Reapers.
Oh, Reapers!
I feel like I've heard that name before.
Oh, you have.
According to the Memory Core, the Reapers were a hyper-advanced machine race that existed 50,000 years ago. The Reapers hunted the Protheans to total extinction, and then they vanished. At least, that's what the Geth believe.
Sounds a little far-fetched.
The vision on Eden Prime. I understand it now. I saw the Protheans being wiped out by the Reapers.
The Geth revere the Reapers as gods, the pinnacle of non-organic life. And they believe Saren knows how to bring the Reapers back.
The Council is just going to love this.
Yeah, well, they need to know.
This is a lot to handle. They might just ignore everything we tell them.
No matter what they think about the rest of this, those audio files prove Saren's a traitor.
The Captain's right. We need to present this to the Council right away.
What about her? The Quarian?
My name is Tali. You saw me in the alley, Commander. You know what I can do. Let me come with you.
You want to join the Shepard train? Sure.
I'll take all the help I can get.
Thanks. You won't regret this.
Anderson and I will go ahead to get things ready with the Council. Take a few minutes to collect yourself, then meet us in the tower.
Yep, and now we have Tali in our team. We have one more person left, but we won't be getting them for a little while. But yeah, Tali is all tech. Because that's a very Quarian thing to be. Yeah, let's roll this way, because I wanna get her set up. Thank you. Tali. All right, Omni Tool, because right, she's by us. She is. Yeah, let's give that to her. There's a lot of things we should Omni-Gel. We need all the Omni-Gel. I have maxed out at 999 Omni-Gel before, and I'm not afraid to do it again. Also, we need to level her up. We need to level us up as well. Rex. I want to max out your combat armor. Tali! And I want to give you some points of basic armor as well. Alright. So now we can go do that thing at Cora's Den that I wanted to do. What happens if you say no? I'm not sure. Oh, this guy. Okay, this guy's fun.
Commander Shepard, my name is Samesh Bhatia. Forgive the intrusion, but I have nowhere else to turn.
It's no trouble. What can I do for you?
My wife was a Marine. She was in the 212 on Eden Prime. I've requested that my wife's body be returned to me for cremation, but the military has refused my request.
Why did they refuse your request? There's got to be some reason.
I don't know. All I know is that they have declared it impossible for my wife to be returned to me.
We'll look into it.
The man in charge of my case is Mr. Bosker. When I last saw him, he was in the expensive bar over there. Thank you for your time. I just want to give my wife a proper funeral and the respect she deserves.
This is an interesting quest. This is a quest of morality. It's a very tiny quest, but you'll see what I mean when, because we're going to go talk to this asshole and we're going to find out why his wife's body is not allowed to be given to him.
My goodness, you're Commander Shepard. Your activities made for quite a briefing in the Diplomatic Corps. Is there something I can do to assist you?
Yes. A man named Samesh Bhatia is having some trouble claiming his wife's body.
Ah, Mr. Bhatia. A good man in an understandably frustrating position. I wish I could help him. Serviceman Nirali Bhatia died on Eden Prime, as Mr. Bhatia no doubt told you. Her wounds are inconsistent with any type of weapon damage we've seen before. That is why her body is being held.
You're studying her injuries to learn more about Geth weaponry.
The tests we're conducting may lead to better defenses against Geth attacks. Respectfully, Serviceman Bhatia may save more lives in death than she did in life.
So, we have an interesting dilemma here. Is the fact that Samesh morally deserves his wife's body better than the fact that that experimenting on her body could save countless lives. Yeah. I don't care.
I understand what you're trying to do, but holding the body is wrong.
It is wrong.
Commander, you of all people should understand how far we must go to protect humanity.
Is this what I'm out here fighting for? A government that steals the bodies of its honored dead?
All right, Commander. You win. It was hard enough refusing Mr. Bhatia. I'm not going to risk an incident by refusing you. Tell Samesh that the body is being shipped back to Earth. I'll go now to see to it myself.
Yeah, that's right. Bitch. We're gonna be coming back here a couple more times. You. I've got my eye on you, Nasana. We'll deal with you later. Actually, can we deal with you now? I don't know if we can.
I don't have time to talk now. I'm very busy.
Okay. And you're a jerk diplomat. Yeah. So Red Celesta is not oh, whoa! Are you okay over there? Hey, sorry lady, are you okay over there? What are you doing? Okay. Bye.
Hello again, Commander. Has there been any word?
I reminded Mr. Bosker what we're fighting for. Your wife is coming home.
Thank you. I will return home and begin my preparations. It does not bring me happiness, but it may bring me peace. Goodbye, Commander.
Peace! Who is Nasana? You will find out when we deal with her. She is an interesting lady. Alright, we gotta go back to Kor's den and find this guy for the consort. And as I was saying before we got into that firefight last time, the Asari are like the typical sexy blue alien space chicks. They're interesting, but... Screw you, Harkin. Yeah, Septimus!
Commander! What do you want?
I'm here on Shayura's behalf. Your lies are hurting her.
Good! Her lies have been killing me for days. I've seen a lot of horrible things in my days, and... there's only one woman in this damn galaxy that helps me forget it.
This is the great Turian general. How did your kind ever defeat us?
Yeah.
I may be drunk, Krogan, but you're ugly. Tomorrow I'll be sober. Unless you have a cure for this ache in my gut. Go away.
Some general. What kind of example are you to your troops?
The troops can kiss my leathery backside. All I wanted was to retire and be with her. Look, kid, I appreciate what you're trying to do, but don't waste your time.
You need to start acting like a general if you want to beat this.
I spent all my life acting like a general, and what did it get me?
But can we not do this?
No, those days are over. I'll just be what I am. A tired, lonely, worn-out soldier.
You're a damn general. Quit your whining.
Ha! You got balls, kid. There are only 5 people in this damn galaxy who talk to me like that.
Yeah, and in the morning he'll be sober.
It's that easy. Just straighten up and act like a general.
Yeah.
It's better than sitting on your ass all day.
Huh. Maybe you're right, Commander. Shaira's worth the effort. Even if she won't have me back.
This is no place for someone of your stature, General.
All right. I'll go to her. After I've had a cold shower or two. Say, you're a bright kid. Would you be interested in earning a few extra credits?
Nah.
I've already got a lot on my plate, General.
You sure? It's a simple job. It won't take you long at all.
What do you want me to do?
There's an L-Corp diplomat out
there. Oh yeah, we want to do this.
I believe Shaira gave up his secrets.
Why would he think such a thing?
Because I told him. Look, I just need you to convince him of the truth.
What makes you think he'll believe me?
You'll bring him proof. Take this data pad. It shows where I got my info. We'll exonerate Shaira and convince the L-Corp.
Alrighty.
Who am I taking you to? And where is he?
His name is Zaltan. He's an L-Corp diplomat. He's over in the embassies complaining about Shaira. Well, here's to soldiers acting like soldiers.
Seriously.
Thanks, Commander. You know, you might make a good general yourself one day.
Interesting thought. So basically, just to give you a little bit of background on what that conversation was all about, because there was some interesting stuff that was kind of dropped in that conversation. The Turians are an incredibly military-based race. The military is life and death for them. So that's why, like, that shit got so real for him. But also, you heard Rex tell him, you know, you're pathetic, and you were the ones that, you know, that defeated us. And I won't tell you why until we hear about it, because I like watching you guys discover stuff, but, once upon a time, the Krogans got a little, just a little too rowdy, and to put it lightly, and the Turians kind of had to put them down a little bit. So there's some tension between them. We want to go back to the embassies. Yeah, I love that. I love that line. I may be drunk, but you're all ugly, and in the morning I'll be sober. You ain't getting any prettier, Rex. I'd still do him, though. I love Rex. I think I might end the video after I do this. I might end the stream. But we're gonna just be streaming nothing but Mass Effect until I finish this. I don't care. Yes, they are very service and community-minded. That is very true. Alright, so now we're gonna get to talk to the Alcor!
Hello there, human. Sincere apology. But I am here on business and cannot be distracted right now.
You see, he's stating his emotions before his words because... what are emotions?
I've come to talk to you about your little problem.
Curious. What do you know about the consort and her relationship to me?
It was a Turian named Septimus who found out your secret.
Unbelieving. I know this Septimus. And he could not learn my secrets. The only way he could learn them is from the Asari consort.
You are mistaken. See this here if you don't believe us.
Confused. This is difficult to fathom. If the Turian could learn this on his own, dismayed, anyone can discover my secret.
Septimus is a powerful man, and it wasn't easy for him to find.
Relieved. I suppose you are correct, human. Thank you for this information. Startled realization.
Yes, that is true, Curry.
I must speak with the consort. She will be most displeased with my actions. Anxious request. Please, human, if you will excuse me, I must go now.
So long.
Farewell, human. Thankful. That was a great thing you did, Commander. Approving. You see, Din, not all humans are as you say.
I'm sure the Earth Clan stands to profit from this in some way.
Man, didn't Korlak his little shit?
Apologetic. Right. Do not listen to my voice, company.
Yes, but Curry is right. They actually communicate with pheromones, but most people can't smell them. So because there's no inflection in their voice, oh, I'm glad to see your legs are working again. Nice to see. Because you can't really hear the inflection in their voice, they just kind of, they state what they're feeling before they speak. So this way you kind of understand where they're coming from. I forget if we have talk to her, if we can just walk in. Yeah, we can just walk in.
It may sound strange, but I simply felt calm. That's not strange. Many of us have felt the same calling. Though you are the first.
Commander, I recently received a lovely note from Septimus. Thank you for speaking with him. Even the Alcor diplomat has withdrawn his campaign against me.
It was my honor to aid you.
You are too kind, Commander, but I would not expect you to help me out of the kindness of your heart. I also have one more thing to give you, if you are interested.
I'd be honored.
I offer a gift of words, an affirmation of who you are and who you will become.
Yeah.
I see your skin, tough as the scales on any Turian, unyielding. A wall between you and everyone else, but it protects you. Makes you strong. It is that strength that people are drawn to. It is why you lead and others follow without question. You will need that leadership in the battles to come. This may be who you are, but it is not who you will become. It only forms the basis for your future greatness. Remember these words when doubt descends, Commander.
You have quite a gift, Shaira.
Thank you. Not everyone appreciates it as you do. Never underestimate the power of words. Here, Commander.
Sure.
In light of your efforts with the Alcor Ambassador, I would like you to have this small trinket.
What is it?
A small mystery. I have never learned its use or purpose, but I sense it is time for me to pass it on. And now I must ask you to leave. I have done everything I can for you.
Yeah, that little,
words, Commander Shepard. They will give you strength.
That little item, we can uncover the mystery of what it is. I forget how we do that, though. It's been a long time since I've played this game. Let's see what other quests we have to do. Oh, first we leveled up. Yeah, we want to reduce our cooldown time, for sure. Let's do that. Oh yeah, I also wanted to see. Well, how could there be in talking with him? Right, okay, so we found some information on Fist while we picked up that information. So let's go give it to our friend Emily Wong. She was near the med clinic.
Thank you.
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
How would you know?
I got a tour. One of 500 to see the Ascension from the inside out.
Really?
Took almost 6 hours and we only saw 1/10 of the ship. I even got to meet the commander.
That's pretty cool.
Matriarch LaDania. You met her?
Well, she addressed everyone on the tour, but I got pretty close.
Word on the street is that you've been busy. Congratulations on taking down Fist.
You're very well. Well, thank you.
I was sure he was a big player in anything going on here.
Yeah.
Did you find anything in his office that could help me?
These OSDs might have the information you're looking for.
Here you go.
You've got Fist files? This could be even bigger than I'd hoped. Here, Commander, for your trouble.
What would my future cooperation be worth? Say, an interview when my investigation is over?
Exclusive? You talk to me before you talk to anyone else? That would be worth quite a bit, and I'd be very happy to compensate you accordingly. Here you are.
Yeah, just basically give us more money.
I should go see what's on these discs.
Yeah, basically just give me the money. Alright, so these I've already done. We investigate that system. We'll do that when we leave. We cannot talk to Conrad again yet. We can talk to him multiple times, and we will, but it depends on, It depends. We have to get to a certain points in the game first before he's available to talk to again. I can't tell you when the next point is, but we'll go see him again when we're there. Can't go wrong with her. Wow, Shelties! Really? Alrighty. You know what? Let's do this. I was gonna end it here, but you know what? Just for that, we're gonna go one step further. Emily Wong is great. Okay, don't make fun of her name. Alright? Alright. It faces us backwards. I hate that it does that.
Not on a date yet.
Yeah, shut up, Chorwan. I don't want to deal with you yet. Alright.
Come on. Udina's presenting the Quarian's evidence to the Council.
Eden Prime was a major victory. The beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
And one step closer to the return of the Reapers.
You wanted proof? There it is.
This evidence is irrefutable, Ambassador. Saren will be stripped of his Spectre status, and all efforts will be made to bring him in to answer for his
crimes.
That's
right!
I recognize the other voice, the one speaking with Saren. Matriarch Benezia.
Matriarch Benezia!
She must be working with the Geth, too.
Matriarch Benezia is a powerful biotic, and she had many followers. She will make a formidable ally for Saren.
I'm more interested in the Reapers. What do you know about them?
Only what was extracted from the Geth's memory core. The Reapers were an ancient race of machines that wiped out the Protheans. Then they vanished.
And matriarchs are higher ups in Asari society. They tend to be pretty powerful. They have a lot of followers. So yeah, the fact that a matriarch is on his side is not comforting news.
The Geth believe the Reapers are gods, and Saren is the prophet for their return.
We think the conduit is the key to bringing them back. Saren's searching for it. That's why he attacked Eden Prime.
Do we even know what this conduit is?
Curry, her amps are in her boobies. Yeah! Benezia's, got two large plot lines involved with her. Yeah, that's a thing. Do we even know what the conduit is? Not yet.
Saren thinks it can bring back the Reapers. That's bad enough.
Listen to what you're saying. Saren wants to bring back the machines that wiped out all life in the galaxy? Impossible. It has to be. Where did the Reapers go? Why did they vanish? How come we found no trace of their existence? If they were real, we'd have found something.
The Reapers are... You doubted me before, yeah.
I tried to warn you about Saren and you refused to face the truth. Don't make the same mistake again.
This is different. You proved Saren betrayed the Council. We all agree he's using the Geth to search for the conduit, but we don't really know why.
The Reapers are obviously just a myth, Commander. A convenient lie to cover Saren's true purpose. A legend he is using to bend the Geth to his will.
50,000 years ago, the Reapers wiped out all galactic civilization. If Saren finds the conduit, it will happen again.
Yeah.
Saren is a rogue agent on the run for his life. He no longer has the rights or resources of a Spectre. The Council has stripped him of his position.
That is not good enough. You know he's hiding somewhere in the Traverse. Send your fleet in!
A fleet cannot track down one man.
A Citadel fleet could secure the entire region, keep the Geth from attacking any more of our colonies.
Or it could trigger a war with the Terminus systems. We won't be dragged into a galactic confrontation over a few dozen human colonies.
Yeah, these councilmen are assholes.
I can take Saren down.
The commander's right. There is a way to stop Saren that doesn't require fleets or armies.
No, it's too soon. Humanity is not ready for the responsibilities that come with joining the Spectres.
You don't have to send a fleet into the Traverse, and the ambassador gets his human Spectre. Everybody's happy.
Well, I mean, it is a thing.
Commander Shepard, step forward.
This scene, though.
It is the decision of the Council that you be granted all the powers and privileges of the Special Tactics and Reconnaissance Branch of the Citadel.
That is what Spectre stands for.
Spectre is not trained, but chosen. Individuals forged in the fire of service and battle. Those whose actions elevate them above the rank and file.
Spectres are an ideal, a symbol, the embodiment of courage, determination, and self-reliance. They are the right hand of the Council, instruments of our will.
Spectres bear a great burden. They are protectors of galactic peace, both our first and last line of defense. The safety of the galaxy is theirs to uphold.
You are the first human Spectre, Commander. This is a great accomplishment for you and your entire species.
I'm honored, Counselor.
We're sending you into the Traverse after Saren. He's a fugitive from justice, so you are authorized to use any means necessary to apprehend or eliminate him.
I'll find him.
This meeting of the Council is adjourned.
So yes, we have become a Spectre! And it's about damn time.
Congratulations, Commander.
We've got a lot of work to do, Shepard. You're going to need a ship, a crew, supplies.
You'll get access to special equipment and training now.
Yep.
You should go down to the CSEC Academy and speak to the Spectre Requisitions Officer.
Anderson, come with me. I'll need your help to set all this up.
Yeah, we're gonna get our own crew, we're gonna get our own ship, it's gonna be sweet!
Bastard didn't even thank you.
What do you expect from a politician? Come on.
Really?
Right behind you, Shepard.
Spectre training, charm, and intimidate talents have been unlocked now that we are Spectre. Okay, so I'm gonna save here, and we're gonna pick this up tomorrow at our 7 p.m. stream, but I think this is a good place to leave off because we just became a Spectre! This is gonna open a bunch of small side quests that we get to do, and we're going to get to leave the Citadel and start hopping around the galaxy a little bit. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope that you're enjoying Mass Effect so far. This is my favorite series of all time, and I will see you guys very soon. I'll stick around in the chat for a little bit, but I'm gonna shower and head to bed and all that good stuff. But if you're watching on YouTube, thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you guys soon.